Live, we're live now. We're live. Good evening, everyone, and welcome. This is Twitch Game Night, where you get to play board games with us. Tonight, we're going to be doing our weekly Twitch Plays Kingdom Death Monster stream, and we're going into Lantern Year 15.
Yes.
It's a quarry hunt, right?
It's a quarry hunt.
Okay. Yeah. So, first, let's backtrack. Introduction time, in case they forget.
If they're new.
Or if they're new. That's true.
I'm Josh.
And I'm TP, which means you guys play and I control the board and you listen to what you have to say.
Twitch proxy.
Twitch proxy.
Yeah.
Yes.
Twitch proxy. Yes, I'm blonde. I did it.
Who's that?
Cage.
Yes.
Finally. And so, Josh, can you give us a recap of what happened last week? I think we had three fights,
yes.
Didn't we?
Last year we did 3 years.
We went last to go fight week we did
last
3 years.
Last week.
Yeah.
So we went and fought the Sunstalker, which was the worst fight
ever. Oh my god, that was rough.
And even chat was like, yeah, Sunstalker shouldn't be that bad. First card we drew was his legendary action card. He had one in the deck. Mm. Chances of you milling that out before it even comes up
are pretty high.
Typically high. For your first card, knocks us all down. So we can't do anything. He goes again. Had a really strong attack after that. And just whittled us down. We then ran away from the fight.
Two of us ran away.
Then we realized we actually didn't have the innovation for it in a way, so they ended up on the board behind us, which needs to be updated.
We killed them after the fact.
Yes. We retroconned. That's what chat said.
Retconned.
But yeah, so that happened. So we basically lost 4 survivors. We fiddled that around a little bit. Then after that, who did we fight after that?
The hand. King's the hand? The hand.
Yeah, I believe we fought the hand after that,
yeah.
Which was a...
boring fight.
Not a fight I like doing on stream. It's just kind of long and boring.
Yeah.
But we did that. Wasn't horrible.
Beat the crap out of him,
yeah,
really.
Beat the crap out of him. We also then had 3 saviors born.
Yeah, we did.
Yes, which was awesome. So we had a red, a blue, and a green.
And then we decided to go out and go for the understanding elite hacksaws,
yeah,
with the white lion.
With the white lion. So we took our 3 saviors and
the
our new bow guy.
Yeah.
We fought the white lion. It worked out so perfectly.
2 of our saviors got ageless.
Yeah, 2 of our saviors got ageless, which had each one had a 20% chance. So 2 out of 4 got it. Pretty good odds. So now our red and our green savior, which are probably my 2 favorites.
Mm-hmm.
Green for sure.
We never really play with a blue savior. I think we tried it once, and I think the same thing happened where we got ageless for our red and our green, and then we didn't get ageless for our blue savior.
Yeah, maybe. So we have this red and green savior that are pretty cool. The red savior is named Panda Panda.
Panda Panda!
Which,
yay,
is like Twitch's new character, because TP is also Panda.
Because
people don't know this.
Oh, is that why?
And then...
because I'm chunky.
There you go.
And then our green savior is named Pancakes.
Yes!
The stack of pancakes is a mighty tank.
Yeah, all shall fear the pancakes.
So that happened, and that was the it. That was the it. So put Katie polls up for people who haven't been here. So for people
last
who haven't been here and everything,
feel free to vote. It's going to be on who our next quarry monster is, names for future survivors, and then suggestions. Who's going to leave on the hunt? Who's going to depart? And then also suggestions for events and stuff, right?
Yeah, there's suggestions and stuff. For people who haven't played, go ahead and vote for what you like. And, I mean, that's what Twitch already does, and they make our lives difficult, and it'll be interesting what we're going to have to fight.
Exactly.
So, while you guys were talking...
Yes.
Narflex said something pretty funny.
Kerfunkel.
While we were introducing ourselves, he said... I'm Kerfunkel, nice to meet you. Oh, wait, this isn't Katie, I'm anonymous? Oops. And I just had to wait to...
Very appropriate.
So one of the things I missed on last time before we signed off was we're supposed to do the Hooded Knight event.
Ah, so we're going to start out with that?
So we're going to start off with that. I think it's tie for who it will go to.
Oh, that's right, because Mo's dead.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Oh, shoot. Sorry, Cage.
What happened with Cage?
There, now you can join to your heart's content.
Ah. So for those of you that have not already, you can join up in the queue, so you could roll dice for us. That's !join or join queue. And whenever there's a dice roll that's needed, we'll be pulling the next person in the queue for you to roll for us, whether it be D10s, D100s, or hit location dice.
D5s, too, now and then, right?
That's true, the rare D5.
It
so,
is a little awkward having this so much higher than it normally is. Because it was much closer than it's higher, so it looks like I'm always looking down when I'm just looking at the screen. Don't look at me like that.
First world problems.
My head hurts just thinking about you talking.
It's the blonde.
Yeah. I'm going to have to start calling you Priscilla.
Wow.
What?
Wow.
Like Cat knows about that.
No, like Elvis's wife.
Low blow. Like, oh, like our savior.
Yeah. What's the name Priscilla?
There was a character named Priscilla.
No,
Survivor.
Not a savior.
It was not a savior.
Yeah. Okay.
So we need D10 to be rolled.
Yes, we do.
Wow, Cage. Cage says...
Cage says...
Hi, Nicholas. Hang on. Let me put the next person. Cage, roll, please. No.
What?
Cage rolled a 9. The blonde hair makes Panda look more albino than usual. I hate you.
That's tough.
And Never Knows says, should point the camera up more so we can see just the forehead.
Yeah. It's not a forehead, actually.
Think about doing bangs, but Josh won't let me.
It is a 5-head.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Josh
is playing with his phone at the table.
I'm seeing something real quick.
Josh won't let me.
I just want to check something.
Do you really want to look more silly, or...?
Right, so they rolled a 9.
They rolled a 9. What am I reading? Mysterious Agenda?
Yeah.
The Hooded Knight forces a tattered parcel into the hands of the returning survivor with the most hunt XP.
What's
tied that? If tied, randomized. Bleh. The Hooded Knight leaves with unfinished business.
Alright, so, since all our top day survivors returning are all...
Saviors.
They cannot receive the Firelight Sword. Because it's another item.
Oh, is it going to be my bow guy?
But, no. But we do get the cool cloak back.
Why do we get the cloak back?
Because that's the little sticker I haven't put in the book. It says he also brings the cloak.
Ah, okay. Oh, so they just, since they're tied, they just can't get it, so he just leaves with unfinished business.
Yes.
So he's going to return in 4 years.
Yep. So he can't give them the sword because the sword's actually cursed. So that item he can actually technically hand to them, but they can't use it because we're in the settlement. That's how I'm going to go with it.
Okay, whatever.
One of those weird rules, but we got the cool cloak back.
So what next, Josh?
So that's that. Then we're talking about endeavors and stuff.
How many endeavors do we have?
We have 5 endeavors.
And that's the innovating we already did, correct?
Yes, that's taking out because we had 6?
Yes.
Is the font for chat smaller now?
Should be.
You could hit control
on the actual full screen? Or in the chat itself?
No, on the overlay.
It might be.
Is there a way that I can fix that possibly?
Not easily while we're streaming right now.
Okay.
Sorry, guys.
Sorry.
I can update it for next time. We got our new computer up, so...
Yay!
I had to redo all the overlays and everything, so things might be a little...
And we're very proud of you for it, Josh.
Little look. So when does Hooded Knight happen again?
4 years.
Casey Kasem says, I'll do it at 100. Matt shaves his beard and head.
I'm not shaving my head.
Oh, so Casey Kasem and all of everyone else who was with me yesterday, all of everyone else, we're doing an Everlife stream on Saturday.
A what?
An Everlife.
Extra life
stream on Saturday, November 5th for 24 hours, and we are going to have goals, and if those goals are met, Matt, Josh, and Aaron are dyeing their beards.
Or purple.
But it's like Breast Cancer Awareness Month, right? Isn't
October
it?
Is Breast Cancer
exactly,
Awareness
this
Month.
Month.
But that's
but we're doing it in November.
But we're planning it.
But at the same time, Twitch is purple.
Twitch is purple. It'll be a pretty color. Pretty colors all around.
All right. Another note for people who haven't been here before. If you want to help support the channel, there's a little tip section. You can name survivors and do other cool stuff. If you
choose our next quarry monster.
Yeah.
It is 24 continuous hours. We'll probably be doing it from like 10 a.m. on November 5th, which is Saturday, to 10 a.m. on Sunday, which is also my birthday.
So there'll be a birthday party at midnight.
I'll be sleeping all day on my birthday just for you guys.
You'll be Panda.
It is for charity. It goes toward the Miami Children's Hospital. And
100% of all tips during that stream.
You guys are going to donate directly there. We're going to do our best to have raffles to celebrate and give incentive for... donating toward them, and thanks for following Casey Kasem. I'm kind of pissed that he wasn't already
followed. You followed. You don't know.
And the other thing that I wanted to say about that was, oh yeah, any tips that we get this month. Although we normally do $100 going to an extra stream, we're going to use that money to fund the extra live stream. So we'll buy extra things to give away. We'll buy the supplies to mess with the guys and bleach and hair dye and all these fun things. So if you guys help this month, it'll really go towards making next month's stream really awesome.
Woo! So Josh, what are you looking at?
I just want to double check something while we're doing this. So, I actually don't think we have that many actual
endeavors.
Numbers. I think I copied that number wrong.
Ah, good job, Joshua.
I think we only have 3 left.
I believe that makes more sense because we didn't lose anyone.
Lose anyone
after that final fight, and I don't think anyone has Tinker, correct?
No one has Tinker. But yes, we have 3 endeavors left. So the other thing we did was we innovated the Clan of Death, which is awesome.
Fantastic. So now is the time to definitely make babies.
The time to make babies is now. But I know they were wanting to make the weapon crafter and build a Zombot.
Do it.
So we have the resource to do that, so I'm going to do that.
We also have 2 love juices to make babies.
And we do have 2. Oh, here's the question. I really would like to make another monster grease. We can use the lion testes to make the monster grease, but we can't make a frenzy potion.
But we love lion testes.
Huh. I think so, I'd rather have the frenzy potion now.
And use one of the love juices for
monster grease.
Monster grease?
Yeah. Because we have 2 love juices.
We have 2. So we still have 1, and then we still would have 2 more endeavors to try to make babies.
Correct.
So it's not like end of the world, but I did have that wrong. 6.
Okay, so are you making the
Yeah, I will make that, and I will use all my So I'm going to do all that. You're going to use the last monster grease, or the last love juice to make a baby.
Okay, so chat, I need a Twitch proxy. Please pull the next 2 people in the queue to roll D10s for intimacy rolls.
Just a second, before we do that.
Before we do that,
you do the love juice, go ahead. Before we use the endeavors, though. There's something I wanted to bring up.
Do you have a macro for what's a macro? I don't know what macro is.
And macro is like a preset command?
I don't think you have a preset command for the Tales from the Tavern Kickstarter. They do have 3 hours left, and
they could use the help right now.
So I'm going to link it here, and if anyone ever wants it again, we're more than happy to share it.
So for those that don't know, Mark, a friend of the show, has come on multiple times to show off the game. It's been a fun game.
I'm blonde because of him.
They're in the home stretch of their game right now.
And they've been trying to do that.
And they've been trying to do that, yes.
Yes.
They've been trying. They have like 3-4 hours
that
left.
That game, if you play with the drinking rules and with Matt pouring the drinks,
yeah,
you
I think,
get drunk.
I think I was more of the issue there. Yeah. I pour a stiff cocktail.
You pour a stiff something.
Ew.
He has to pour it? That's kind of weird.
So, Never Knows rolled a 3, and Mr. Frightful rolled a 7.
A 7. The settlement gains +1 pop. Do we have bed, Josh?
No.
Oh, that would have been nice. Settlement gains +1 population. The male and the female survivors gain +10 survival each.
They also get +1, actually, +1 strength, +1 evasion, no, +2 strength, plus
yeah.
1 evasion.
That's what I say. If we had,
and 1 understanding.
If we had bed, it would be another +1 strength.
Yeah. No bed yet.
So I can't wait
till
we get
do it
bed.
On the ground.
And we did it on the ground. So, Twitch Proxy, if you could look at the KD polls and tell me what the next name... Do we have any names in the queue?
I don't think we do.
I don't believe we do.
I think we're all caught up, I believe.
So, 1 accuracy, 2 strength, 1 evasion, 1 understanding.
1 survival.
And 1 survival. And the limit is 6, Josh?
Yes, the limit is 6.
Let's see. Ooh, we have 23 responses. So what am I looking for?
Survival name. Survivor name.
New survivor names.
Yep, it's a baby.
It's going to be... Oh, Valkmule is going to be so happy about this.
Oh, it's a pun name, isn't it?
Sausage.
That's a food name.
That's a food
he
name.
Doesn't care about food names.
You don't care about food names?
No, it's the pun names he doesn't like. Sausage.
Does that mean it's a boy? That's a pun.
I was going to say, it would have to be a boy,
that's
I'm assuming.
Kind of a pun.
Sausage.
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 Now we just need peppers and onions.
I think the original name was supposed to be sausage and rolls or something, but I...
There's one that also says rolls. Then, what are the next ones, if we get to make another one?
Don't tell me. I want it to be a surprise.
It's a fun.
It's a fun.
So, Cage says, Matt doesn't love sausage. Could have fooled me.
Oh, I do like right. sausage.
So I used the one endeavor.
Yes.
And I used our resource. Oh, let me update the resource list. I need to make monster boosts. So here's the question. Frenzy drink.
We do have.
So we can bury the Zomboto and or the Ooh. Guitar.
Ooh. Bury that Zomboto. Do it. Do it.
But that requires an endeavor.
I don't care. Do it. I say do it.
What does chat say?
So, chat, we have the option to bury the Zomboto and or guitars. Guitar?
One guitar.
And what that's going to do is that's going to calcify it, I believe. And it removes the fragile from the weapon, no?
That makes it a little bit stronger.
So what are we doing? What are the choices? What should we do?
Do we want to bury the Zomboto? / guitar?
No, so you're doing a pull?
Yeah.
Don't bury. Bury Zomboto. Bury guitar.
Bury both.
Bury both.
Do you think that I know how to spell this?
Zambato.
Okay.
And Katar.
So the Zomboto. Okay.
The Zomboto is a very solid weapon. So it removes frail, not fragile. That's what I meant to say.
But it goes from. The accuracy goes up to a 5 plus instead of a 6.
Okay, so it gets easier to hit.
And the strength goes up from a 6 to an 8.
Ooh. Well, that's a... And it's still devastating one.
Yeah, but the green... No. Some of them, the affinity switch on them, but they don't. They're still the same.
Yeah, it still has devastating one. And deadly. What is deadly again? You roll another...
Deadly is a plus 1 luck.
Oh, plus 1 luck. That's right.
Devastating one is it does an additional wound when you do one.
Yeah, so the Zomboto... The calcified Zomboto is solid. I would... That would be really fun to give that to the Red Savior.
Oops, don't bury.
Yeah,
let's just say don't bury, but don't buy.
Don't buy.
Whoops.
Oh, TP.
Don't buy. Right now, 100% saying bury Zomboto.
Just the Zomboto?
Just the Zomboto.
Okay, so I need you to grab the Dung Beetle Knight book. And,
Hey, Blue Sapphire, how you doing?
We're gonna go to Black Harvest.
Well, you gotta hold your horses, mister. Dung Beetle Knight, that's poop. Black Harvest. The settlement nominates a survivor to be the gatherer. So, Twitch, please nominate a survivor.
What does it say about the gatherer?
The gatherer performs one of the following events, depending on the level of the Black Harvest. In addition, the settlement may unbury gear that they have encased and bury...
Sorry. I do underground, so...
Oh my God,
Black Harvest
Josh.
Is what?
Okay, the settlement laboriously works the ground. Prepare the farm. In addition, you may encase and bury gear. Nominate one or more survivors to be farmers. A survivor cannot be a farmer if they have already endeavored elsewhere this settlement phase. All farmers toil underground, pulling weeds, nightmare weeds, and fighting seed-eating insects. The farmers cannot depart.
So, I would say you get pluses for every survivor, right?
Roll 1d10, adding the number of farmers to the result.
So, who do we have going to be the part?
Hi, Kiganis. Kiganis says Josh should be a farmer.
Josh is a farmer.
So, give us some of our options.
What he's going to suggest is that we take the departing survivors, set them aside, and use all the non-departing survivors for this, just to increase our numbers.
Okay.
So, they'll be farmers.
So... Who are the departing survivors, Twitch Proxy?
The departing survivors, so wait, that's the no more baby making?
Yep.
Well,
just wait, just...
Okay. Can still do one baby making later, just...
So the departing survivors now, based on the poll?
Yes.
Okay, so survivors to depart are going to be, wow. Panda Panda.
Okay.
Pancakes.
Okay.
Reinhardt.
Okay.
Who's Reinhardt?
One of the newborns.
And Doucheface Matt Lester.
Oh, they did not let you take the Not-So-Slender Man.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
The Not-So-Slender Man's so good, though.
That should be the king. Is that an option? And TP should be the evil sorcerer. Sorceress, thank you.
You are an evil sorceress.
And we also have the one new baby, right?
Yes, we have the one new baby. Sausage. Sausage.
So Sausage can go with the farmers. Baby farmers.
How many farmers are there?
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 farmers.
Do we want to try and make a baby first to see if we have an additional farmer?
Sure. Why don't we try to make a baby first? Have someone roll a d10.
I don't know what you're showing me.
Can you roll a d10? Sorry.
That's what you're showing
me. Can you pass it over to me?
She wants yours.
Ah. Oh, is that what she
was? That's what she was into.
You next one.
Yes, we need them to roll for the augury.
Nicholas Patton, if you could roll for me, please. Nicholas rolled a 7.
That is a baby.
We're gonna make a baby.
That is a baby.
We need 2 more d10s to be rolled to which proxy.
Okay. Quote ad, Josh, you want to make a baby before we start? Matt. Cajun never knows. If you could please roll 1d10 each. Cajun rolled a 10.
Oh, that's a savior.
Another savior?
So we need another poll. What color savior you want to make?
Oh, but we are... Well, we...
I would say blue. Just because then we can...
Switch choice.
That is switch choice.
Pan is red and pancake is green.
We also have a blue non-ageless savior.
Yes.
Named.
Yami. I can't pronounce
hama,
it.
Hama 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 ha ha.
Hama 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 ha ha.
Yes.
Something like that.
Whole new.
Thank you to Mr. Frightful for his $5 tip.
So what color is your blue, green, and red?
Yep.
Or red.
And can you explain what the difference is?
So yeah, the red savior is the strength savior. So
okay.
For each red affinity, you get plus...
No, each red affinity, he gets an auto hit.
That's right. For each red affinity, and you start with one red affinity, you get an auto hit on one of your attacks. And then for each age milestone you have checked off, you get plus 1 strength. Then you have the green savior, which is the tank savior. So for each green affinity, you get plus 1 armor to all hit locations.
Yep.
And for each age milestone, you get plus 1 evasion. And then finally, there's the blue savior, which is the range savior, the sniper savior.
The range
luck. So for each blue affinity, you get plus 1
range/reach
for your weapon. So you can attack from an additional spot away. And then for each age milestone, you get plus 1 luck.
Yeah.
And I would have liked it more if it was plus 1 accuracy, I think. Just to really make him a sniper savior.
Mm. But the luck's nice.
Bless you.
Excuse me.
Bless you.
So who are you playing as, Matt? Well, you play as Lester. This is a Lester, so he's already got 2 bow.
That's true.
And he's got Thrill Seeker.
What? Oh, Revlo's not
plus
working?
Oh, I might have...
You forgot.
You were asking me to leave the seat, and you wanted to take control.
It's all my fault. Okay, I'm going to give everyone some extra bonus points. Sorry, guys.
So, Twitch proxy. We are going to need a d10 to be rolled for the underground sow.
Okay, a d10 is going to be rolled now.
So we have plus 7 to this roll.
Right.
One, ten.
So we can't get that, where everyone dies.
Oh.
Mr. Frightful, if you could please roll for us, we would appreciate that.
Yeah, because 1 through 6 is all farmers die.
Hey, Belgium's Games, I'm blonde now. I hope you're happy.
He's never happy.
He's never happy. Check out their Kickstarter.
Implying we didn't say to do it earlier.
We totally did. We totally did, I swear. Even Cage did.
And who's rolling for us, you said?
It's going to be Mr. Frightful. Mr. Frightful rolled a 9.
Ooh, a 9 plus a 7?
Yes.
Is 16. The farmers zealously clear the underground farm with aid from the settlement. Add Black Harvest 1 to the timeline 3 years from now and gain 2 vermin resources.
So 3 years?
Yep.
So Black Harvest.
So all farmers and departing survivors, so everyone in our settlement, has vermin obsession disorder.
Okay.
So everyone in our settlement has vermin obsession, which means that as long as there is a bug patch on the board, you cannot spend any survival.
Yes. But we get 2 bugs right now, right?
We get 2 vermin resources right now.
All right. We got a crab spider.
Consume this and gain 3 survival. hide. This is a hide. And then this is a sword beetle. Consume and roll archive and roll a d10. On a 6 plus, you get plus 1 strength. On a 1 through 3, you die. This is the that's the only thing this is used for.
You can use those in cooking recipes.
Oh, can you?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So that there is some, even though we never got cooking
so
on
you
stream.
Hold that.
Hey, Kaylin!
Kaylin, hello!
Nicholas wants to know, what would it take for you to pluck 5 of Matt's eyebrows during the 24-hour stream on November 5th? It would take $100 per hair, right?
I mean, for charity, sure.
How much to cost to shave your eyebrows?
I regularly pluck his eyebrows. He asks me to pluck his eyebrows.
So you missed what Twitch... they were saying they wanted to dye your beard pink?
Yes.
But they also wanted you to shave your beard. And I said, I think you would rather not shave his beard than dye it pink.
Yeah, that is accurate.
So they said they want you to dye your beard pink and then have to shave half of it off.
Okay, but in my defense, I said keep the goatee as pink, like, so you don't have to like walk around with half
no,
a
no,
beard.
No, 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 no. They want half a beard. So remember, we're all setting up our own team page, and the more worse stuff you have happened to you, the more you're gonna beat us and raise in more money because everyone wants to do stuff to you. That's how that works, right?
Sure, why not?
Well, we're all gonna have a competition, and whoever raises the most money is gonna win.
Yeah.
I don't know what they're gonna win. Probably the most torture, but whatever.
Exactly. They're gonna win the biggest headache. So you're going to add the Black Harvest 1 to the timeline 3 years from
hey,
now.
Target.
Black Harvest 1? Okay.
Yes.
And then we have the option of burying, right?
We do not?
Yeah. You also have the option to...
Oh, in addition, you may encase and bury. Nominate one and... Oh. Interesting.
What was the disorder we got? Vermin?
Vermin obsession.
I'm sorry, vermin on these.
Keganis says, how many hairs does Matt have on his chest? I'll see if I can pay to pluck them all. Oh my god.
You would have to be a wealthy man.
Pluck?
You'd have to what?
Be a wealthy man.
Pluck, or do you want to wax off?
Ooh, we can wax
oh
him.
God. We're going to recreate the scene from the 40-year-old virgin.
Yeah. Yes! Ooh, let's do that. Let's, or also Hitch, the back hair. No? Have you seen Hitch?
Yes, I have
yes,
seen Hitch.
Yes. Hey, Best Mike. So, as we mentioned earlier, whoever's just joining us, all tips from this month will go toward making the Extra Life 24-hour stream really awesome, like with giveaways
this isn't and takes an endeavor.
Wax for Matt's
the
chest.
The card says to do underground, so.
Beard dye, all that fun stuff. Dye his chest hair pink as well. Keganis says, is that a challenge, Matt?
Maybe.
You do owe him In-N-Out Burger. Guess what, Matt? I found out that In-N-Out Burger is in Dallas.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have In-N-Out Burger. I'm gonna take pictures of it. And I'm gonna send it to you.
Oh, so for people who don't know, we're actually gonna be at BGGCon.
Yay! Thanks,
well,
Mike.
Me and TP will be.
And possibly Anne.
Yeah, possibly Anne.
Okay, so nominate survivors to be the embalmers. I'm assuming the same ones.
The same ones, yeah. Does it say you can't use
so
them?
It says that you can't use them if they already endeavored elsewhere this settlement phase. But this is all part of the same endeavor.
Yeah, I would say you can use them. That's fine. Yeah, let's say we use them. Whatever.
The embalmers are exhausted. They cannot depart or spend any endeavors this settlement phase. For each embalmer, select one gear with the mineral keyword and spend one preserved caustic dung strange resource. For each piece of gear selected, roll a d10.
We have that.
We don't.
Because we lost all of that.
You suck, Josh.
I forgot that required that.
You suck. Good job, Josh.
So we can't do it?
Nope, we can't bury it. You're a butthole. We wasted that.
You ruined it.
Soiled it.
Well, we have Black Harvest up now.
Mark offered to wax his chest.
Ew. No, Papa.
Case is Matt and Josh. Don't the Black Harvest survivors all die unless they roll like an 8 plus, or am I thinking of some other person?
You add the survivor, the number of survivors to it, and we added 7 of them.
Ah.
And unless it's a 6 plus, then, or yeah, it's, I think it's a 7 plus, they die. But
so,
because we added 7 off the bat, they weren't going to die regardless of what we did. Yep. So
we have Black Harvest that comes up in 3 years.
Is that good, or?
I think we get
hey,
some stuff from that.
We'll find out.
Oh, we'll find out.
I didn't read ahead because of that.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think that's everything now.
We have one never. No, we used the never yep. to make the savior.
Yeah, we used. We made. Oh, so Twitch Proxy, can you pull the poll, and we can see what color our savior's going
to
be?
One more time. For, oh, yeah. Well, that put Katie polls up one more time for people to vote on who we're going to fight.
It is going to be blue.
Ooh, blue savior.
Blue for 4, green for 2, and red for 1. And I'm putting up the Katie polls one more time. You guys still have a chance to vote for what we're going to fight with Quarry.
And Twitch Proxy, can you pull the poll quickly and tell me the next survivor name for our savior?
And if you tip at any time, $5, you'll automatically get to choose the next survivor name. And $20 chooses the next Quarry.
Quarry.
And that will go to our extra live stream to get Matt some wax for his chest.
Yay.
Kaylin says, message sent. I'm going to figure out where he sent that message. Halloween is on a Monday this year. Are you guys planning on doing anything on stream for it?
Unfortunately, we'll be just coming back in town from...
We get back Sunday, so...
Do we? Okay, so we could possibly do something for the stream. We might have, like, a dress-up.
Well, Mondays now are our spotlight streams.
Correct.
But we could do something.
We'll probably dress up or do something fun. Before November 5th, how much would it take for Matt to dance the chicken dance in a chicken suit?
I need a chicken suit.
Well, we need a chicken suit.
Well, you could also always get a chicken kigurumi for me.
Yes.
Oh, we could. Tips? We also take tips for if you want to suggest or demand a specific onesie. I already have a panda onesie, and everyone else is willing to wear a onesie based on what chat demands.
So what's the name of the next survivor?
The next survivor is going to be... it is tied between Roll.
Uh-huh.
It's supposed to be Sausage and Roll for the other name.
Matt's Illegitimate Bastard. Which one I think is my favorite. Valve's Genius Games says, I got into the spotlight game in 3 for you.
Or 3.
We have a bunch to do.
We already have a backlog. This is great.
This is fantastic. This is why we need to go to a weekly thing for that. And Spider Ham.
Okay.
That kind of food and as a...
That's a pun food name, I think. But it's your choice, Twitch Proxy. You're the tiebreaker here.
Hi, Jackson. I'm blonde because Vile Genius Games forced me to do it. Dance, Dance, Panda, and Animal Costumes. We will totally do Dance, Dance, Panda. And I'll definitely dress up as a panda for Halloween. No problem. No problem there.
What are you picking for our survivor name?
Spider Ham.
Spider Ham is male or female?
Spider Ham.
Spider Ham. Does whatever a ham can.
Because she's hammy.
Like Hamtaro?
Like hamster.
Hamtaro was a hamster.
Oh, he acknowledged that I'm blonde. That implies that he is satisfied and I can stop dyeing my damn hair.
Your damn hair.
You know what's funny?
Your face?
You know what's hilarious? The fact that you put my value at $100 and it cost me about $275 between when all said and done. And I only get a third of that.
That's your fault. Less than a third.
Less than a third is taxes. And costs and giveaways. And probably like 5%.
Yeah. So, Twitch Proxy, can you pull the poll and see who we're going to be fighting quarry-wise?
Okay. We are going to be fighting...
Let's see how mean Twitch is to us.
The Dragon King.
Okay.
Okay.
We saw at one point that the Lion God was winning, and...
Winning a lot.
Lion God is supposed... we've never fought him. He's supposed to be the most difficult monster that you can fight. At least from what we've heard.
Ooh.
So, Josh, we need to read a story event or anything, or stuff and things?
No, I'm just gonna set up. I'm just getting gear set up for everyone to part in. I'm missing gear.
Uh-oh.
I'm gonna take out your gear.
I'm gonna take out my gear. I'll kill you. Now, we're fighting the tyrant, or...
No,
The big thing.
The big dude.
I'm working on it. Dragon King. Showdown, Dragon King. Okay, so you need to take those things off the board.
Damn it.
You need to clean up here, buddy.
I'm working on it.
You're so unorganized, Joshua. I need the decks. I'll teach you to be slow. Oh, this is going to be a tough one.
Why can't you not eat these things?
Dragon King.
Kate,
let's
know, do we have a disposable survivor to grab the heart?
Excuse me?
The harp?
The heart.
We've never fought the
never
Dragon
fought
King.
We don't know.
Spoiler?
I've never fought the Dragon King.
Cade, you ruined it!
I don't see that anywhere here, so... Whatever. So... Survivors there. I need the Dragon King ones.
Sorry.
I don't know. Nope, that's there. Typey.
I'm
a typing machine.
Barbie girl, Barbie world.
Cornering Mark.
Cornering?
Yeah, cornering.
Why cornering?
All right, I'm gonna give them.
Just bring the non-savior for undisclosed reasons.
We have non-saviors.
Hi, Relinor.
This is Twitch's hand gear. I can't give them the green affinity for the Zombato right now.
Can't?
No. So that's they don't get the deadly.
That's upsetting.
But I also get them the guitar so they can switch off between what they want to use.
Okay. Twitch proxy. Twitch proxy. This is yours. Please set this up in your Twitch hand.
Okay. Give me 1 second.
Give me one good reason, baby. Come on.
This is very, very bad.
Okay, and Joshua, we need the Dragon King, not so miniature.
Well, if we can just a shake. I'm going to give you this gear set, because you're playing range, right?
I guess so. Who am I playing as?
You're going to play as Doucheface Matt, Lester.
Doucheface Matt, Lester.
But he has Thrill Seeker, so whenever he gains survival, he gets 2 survival. So I'm giving you the Rawhide set.
Gain all the survival.
To really max out on that. Just a note, Panda has Burning Focus, so if they have 0 survival at the start of their turn, they get +1 survival.
Right. So it makes sense for you to use up your survival.
Give me 1 second. Tell me when to switch over to the main board.
I will.
I'll play pancakes.
Sorry, guys. I'm not paying attention to chat right this second. Just trying to do setup. Be right there. If anyone's saying anything, I don't know.
Matt, this is your gear.
Yeah.
You ordered this probably awful. Just trying to make sure it looks good in camera. That is my main concern. I don't know how to adjust quality anymore, so hopefully it looks good. And you said not to switch over yet, right?
Not yet. Okay. And this is the Monsters AI deck. Pretty sure I built that correctly. There's the hit location deck.
Shuffle this. Nope, you did not.
I didn't shuffle that yet, no. This was supposed to be in the AI deck also.
In the AI deck? No, this is a beginning. It's listed?
Yeah.
Those are in play.
Oh, okay. Sorry. My fault.
Whatever's listed is in play at the start of the game.
Well, that's handy. It was right there on the bottom.
What is the color of the saber? Panda Jesus. Panda is...
Red Panda.
And then the savior I have is the green savior. And then we have 2 non-saviors.
Doucheface Matt Lester.
Alright.
This must be the extras. Yeah. Almost done yet, Josh?
Yeah,
You're very slow with your gear grids today. And that is yours also.
Because we really need to make a 4th gear grid, a 4th set.
What did you do? You killed it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, let me grab the mini.
I'm actually finally set up.
This took longer than I expected for some reason.
That barely fits in your shelf.
Well, he's big.
He's really big. Twitch Prox, have you seen this one yet?
Nope. Am I ready to switch over?
You are ready to switch over.
Alright, let's do this.
Just turn him a little bit more to
face the camera.
Face the camera.
And Josh, if you could put the survivors there.
He is too tall, actually.
I don't know where my gear grid
forward.
Is.
Like, wait forward. And then angle him. Ready, partner?
Oh, so I'm still bow.
You're still bow.
Good. I like
playing. I gave you the raw high set so you can maximize on your...
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Your thing.
My thing.
So that's why I had to rearrange my whole other character because...
Maximize my thing, Josh.
Nothing. So, Reinhardt, I need the other clipboard.
There you go. And we're ready to start. So, Josh, do you want to go first? Do you want me to go first?
Sure, I'll Reinhardt go first.
So.
Pancakes.
First one is a Dragon King card. Lava Flow. Dragon King Hunt Event. The ground crumbles, revealing an underground river of lava. There is no way forward but through. Hopping from one stone in the flow to the next. Each survivor rolls a d10 and adds their courage. So, Twitch Proxy, I need you to roll a d10, have the next person in the queue, and add your courage to it. Ooh, I rolled a 10. I don't believe you have any courage.
They might have a courage. I have a courage. So no. They might have one. Do you have any courage to get?
Let's see. Courage. Yes, I have one.
Okay. So, whatever their dice roll is, add one to it.
And we're
going to
pick one person, you said?
Yeah,
yes.
One person.
Okay.
This is...
I heard a 7 movement, technically.
Oh, my God.
Nicholas Patton, if you can roll a d10 for us.
Okay,
you know. Vital Genius Games, a.k.a. Mark, said, I can ask around. I asked him if he know anyone who might be willing to sponsor some games for Raffles mm-hmm. for Extra Life. He said that he's got 2 more death rays for us for it.
Ah, awesome. Very cool.
So, thanks so much, Mark.
Papa Mark. And what was your dice roll? Who's rolling, anyways?
Nicholas rolled a 3.
Okay.
So we added the 1.
Yes, so you have 4.
Reinhardt is the loser there.
No. It's we all.
Well, we all get through something.
We all have the exact same thing happen because it's 3 through 13.
Okay.
Exhausted, you make it across. Begin the showdown with an additional lava pool terrain tile on the showdown board.
But not now. It's when we start.
Yeah.
Okay.
So 1 through 2 is terrible.
1 through 2 is like dead.
You're dead and you archive all of your gear.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's nasty.
Ooh, that's real nasty.
That's nasty.
That's nasty. So you want high courage people to go fight the...
Yeah. Granted, that's 1 or 2. So, like, if they have 1 courage, you literally have to roll a 1 to have it happen. But, so, who's next?
Reinhardt.
Dead warrior. We don't have pictographs still, I don't think.
Nope.
God damn it.
So, random hunt.
Random hunt event.
2 out of 100.
200?
Yeah.
I don't know. Leave me alone. Corpse. The survivors are overcome by a sudden chill, their breath seizing in their lungs. The survivors freeze, each losing 1 survival. Everyone, please lower your survival by 1.
You're supposed to get plus survival for leaving, whatever your
survival
gear says.
Survival by 1, so that... Wait, what should I have been at max?
What is your survival?
I was at 4.
Yeah, you would have been at max. So you'd
okay,
be at 5
now.
Okay,
so now we're down to 5, which is technically up 1 because they have the wrong number.
At the center of the sudden frost is a perfectly preserved corpse. We do not have cannibalize, right? We have graves?
No. Yeah.
Did we actually fight the Black Maga? No, we did not.
Matt kind of fought it a little bit.
I fought the Black Maga.
We
for
ran
like
4
turns.
Babies. I grabbed all of its tentacles.
You grabbed 3 of its 4 tentacles.
That
could have teleported out of there and hit you still.
True. the event revealer gains plus 1 courage, plus 1 understanding.
Okay.
Roll a d10.
1.
Nothing happens.
Alright.
Next.
This is Twitch.
Twitch, this is for you. The Cultivated Crypt. You uncover a crypt littered with the preserved corpses of dragons. You may defile the crypt and draw up to 3 random Dragon King resources. Otherwise, gain 1 understanding and roll a random hunt event. So, Twitch Proxy, ask Twitch if they want to defile the crypt of dragons.
That sounds like something Twitch would want to do.
Yeah, probably. Ooh. Oh, this is mean.
Do we want to defile the crypt of dragons? Yes. No. Okay, vote now. I'm going to give it about a minute. Looks like they want to defile.
Oh, Jesus.
And you can draw up to 3. So how many resources do they want to draw?
Hey, Gamergram. Thanks for joining us. Cage says, defile that shit like a drunken prom queen.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Wowzers.
So,
wow.
How much do you want to steal from the dragon?
You can. So, since you guys want to defile the crypt and steal resources, do you want to steal 1, 2, or 3?
You've asked me that before. I've done no, yes, 1 yet. Okay, let's see.
This is a very mean hunt phase.
Wow, okay, so it's definitely yes. Looks like 3. We're going with 3. Everyone's going with 3.
Oh, Jesus.
All right. So,
thanks for following, Numpty.
Numpty. So, because you guys stole 3 resources, the Dragon King begins the showdown with +1 speed token. So he's going to roll an extra dice on each one of his attacks.
+1 damage.
Oh, it's all of them.
All 3 of them happen.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, so he starts with the overheat mood in play. What does the overheat mood, Josh?
Did he build it in the duck?
I don't know.
Yes. I need another random B card. That does not count part of his life.
There's only one more B.
I believe that doesn't count as one of them.
Okay, so what is overheat, Josh?
At the end of each monster's turn, perform eradicate. Discard this melt...
Irradiate.
Irradiate. Discard this one, the meltdown story event is triggered. So, very first turn, he's going to do that.
That's interesting. Okay, he also gets a +1 damage token.
A +1 speed token?
And then a +1 speed token. So he's going to do an extra damage on each one of his attacks, and he does an extra dice roll for
so
each
like
one of his attacks.
So it's like fighting a level 2, or a level 1.
Pretty much.
Okay.
So he doesn't get tougher, he just gets, he hits harder.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was Cultivated Crypt.
Alright.
There's Overheat.
We're going to do Mineral Gathering.
Yeah. Mineral Gathering. So Twitch Proxy, I need you to roll a d10, please.
And we got radioactive dung.
Ooh.
King's Claw.
Okay.
And a veined wing.
Oops. I went to repost something I already posted, and I hit up 1 too many times, and I just said, Vile Genius, you're the best.
Did you really?
By accident, yeah.
That's funny.
I mean, it's not wrong, but...
Mineral Gathering, you need a d10.
Cage rolled a 5.
Okay, you gain a broken lantern resource.
They can reroll this.
Gamergram says this would be a great format for the Robinson Crusoe game.
I have not heard of that one.
I'll
have to check that out.
So, Twitch Proxy, you guys can reroll that one because if you don't, all survivors take 2 event damage to a random hit location.
So, what will we have to do to reroll that thing?
Just reroll it.
Okay.
Your guitar allows you to reroll on the Mineral Gathering.
Mr. Frightful, if you could reroll that, please. And for anyone just joining us, you can help us roll. Just !join to join the queue, and I'll let you know when it's your turn to roll.
So I should have 2 armor at each location, right, Josh?
Mr. Pfeiffer rolled a 9.
Much better.
Okay, great.
You get a scrap.
Is that 9 scrap?
8 plus a scrap.
Oh, scrap. Okay, so we got one. Okay, I'm gonna get that.
Very good, very good. And now, this is my turn. The Thespian Troop. An enormous man in a lion mask pulls a heavily laden rickshaw behind him. You may nominate a survivor to enter the rickshaw. This doesn't seem very good. I could be wrong, though. I'm going to nominate Doucheface Matt Lester to go into the rickshaw. Just because, why not? This is probably a very bad idea. A 9. Or a very good idea. Amidst a chorus of feminine giggling, you depart with a strange white mask. When you wear it, you feel invincible. Gain the unbreakable fighting art. I don't know what that is, but I'm unbreakable now, apparently. Oh, there's so many, Josh. Josh, talk to the camera.
Josh,
talk?
Yeah, I can talk. If I think.
Gage says Matt Lester smells like a Matt needing a blessing in the rickshaw.
So that was that. We're going to start the fight now. What is your thing?
Oh, that's really cool.
What?
Unbreakable. Once per lantern, you may ignore a severe injury roll result.
Oh, so if your head explodes or something, you just
like
no.
You'd be like, no, it doesn't happen.
It doesn't happen.
I get a random disorder when I do that, though.
Okay.
But that's pretty awesome.
That is pretty awesome.
Pretty cool.
That would have been pretty good for the tank, actually.
Tank shouldn't get any severe injury rolls.
That's true.
Would be good for the tank.
My tank also has 9 armor on each chip location.
Oh my goodness.
Because tank is a tank. And he has 1, 2, 3, 4 evasion.
Very cool. And so now, guess what happens?
What happens?
Yeah, we're fighting the Dragon King.
Yay!
So we get 2 doctor's cards.
There once was a monster that was alone in the world. Abandoned in its grief, the monster crawled deep inside its aching heart until it broke and was set aflame. Now the power of its grief and fury pours like invisible poison from the weeping face it hides inside its hulking body. Joshua, I need 2 toppled pillar terrain cards, 1 stone column.
We got a lava pool. Stone columns.
1 stone column and 2 toppled pillars. Oh, goodness.
And we start off with a lava pool in play.
Yeah, that is correct. Adjacent to the monster, I believe it said, right?
I feel like maybe we should zoom out on the board so you can see the whole.
The whole? What do you think? Preparation H does feel good on the whole.
I know I need to lift and take it away. What do you think?
If you think it needs it.
Granted, he's going to be moving. He's going to be moving back right now.
Back is even worse because the head's getting cut off.
Oh,
the height.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So give me 1 second, guys. I'm going to attempt
any
to
randoms?
Adjust the camera angle
terrain?
Just a little bit. Hopefully, it'll result in a better view for you guys.
Any random terrain around?
No random.
So, tell me how I do this. How do I lift?
Unscrew the thing.
This?
No, your other hand. Your other
this?
Hand. Yes. Then just lift it up. Scoot the thing over a little bit because you're hitting the other camera. Is that better?
I think that's better.
Yeah. Okay, so I need the toppled pillar and the stone column terrains. And he starts out with these cards in play. Unseen Agony. All survivors in the blast zone, which is 3 spaces in all directions around the monster, suffer 1 damage for each -1 toughness token the Dragon King has to 1 random hit location. So he's going to give himself -1 toughness tokens, but his attacks go up for each one of the that he has on them, essentially.
Okay.
So he makes him... He sacrifices himself and makes himself easier to hit, or easier to wound, but he deals out more damage. And then Irradiate is a trait. The chest sphincter. He has a chest sphincter. Tugs open, revealing the Dragon King's radioactive heart. The monster gains -1 toughness token. If it has 5 or more -1 toughness tokens, the heart is exposed, perform Meltdown. Otherwise, perform Unseen Agony. Oh, Jesus. So it looks like every turn, he gains a -1 toughness token, and then
kill him fast.
Yeah, and then the space 3 around him, everyone gets a damage to a hit location for each -1 toughness token he has, and then after 5 turns, he's gonna melt down. I'm not exactly sure what meltdown does.
It like kills.
Oh
my
goodness!
Board.
Yes, it does. Holy crap!
This is the reason why Fenn said. Bows are good.
Yeah, I'm very glad that
I brought a bow with the
others. Oh, did you? That's funny. So, there you go. So, the monster is in the middle.
And he has the mood in place, so he is going to do eradicate every turn.
Irradiate. Can you put this with 2 spaces above it and 2 spaces to the left of it? Rotate 90 degrees.
Okay.
Do. Do-do-do-do. They're minerals, Marie. Move. Move. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. There, I think. Okay.
And then this goes next to him somewhere?
Yeah. And what does that say to do?
Lava pool. Spire moves through or ends movement on this terrain. They suffer one damage and return all the flammable gear to set on the storage. So it goes to storage.
Flammable gear.
Yes. If any other terrain placed in this tile, it melts in its archive. If you got from one stone to the other, so you can use a movement to go across it.
Okay, so we
and,
start.
You roll a die and.
Six spaces away from
it's
him.
It's pretty bad.
It's pretty bad.
You need a 7 plus to do. You get a courage.
He is beefy.
Do we actually start at the edge of the board?
The top and bottom, you start at the edges because that's what's 6 spaces away from him. It's raining. I'm going to start you guys next to each other. I'm the bow, so I'm going to kind of chill around on the outskirts.
Did you see
okay.
What Kevin said? Did you respond? Kevin says, wasn't there supposed to be a lava train somewhere because of one of the cards?
Yeah,
yep, we put it on.
I don't have chat. I don't know why you're asking
oh,
if I saw this.
Oh, because he said okay, just making sure. So I didn't know if you responded.
Oh, yeah,
no,
we put it on.
We put it on there. And then we got these two...
The block formation, so if we're in a square, while the survivors are standing in this formation, they may ignore the first hit from a monster's attack. That's solid. And in the trip formation, once per showdown during your act, if you are directly in front of the monster and there are two survivors in the blind spot, you may spend an action to trip the monster. The monster suffers knockback one away from you and is knocked down.
So it gets knocked back into the two people standing in the blind spot?
Yeah.
Which is weird.
But you sacrifice it so you could be like, I'm going to hit you really hard.
Yeah, all right. Block formation could be cool, but you're standing all the way over there, so it doesn't matter.
Okay, so monster's turn first, and you're going to start off as monster controller, because I said so.
Thanks. Always starts off as monster controller. All survivors in the blast zone.
Oh, just to point out, too, the monster has a movement of 10 and a toughness of 13.
Cage wants to know, can you use the block formation to negate meltdown?
I believe so.
Of a monster's attack.
It says the first hit from a monster's attack, and I don't believe meltdown's an attack.
So when does this happen?
Unseen Agony?
Yeah.
I do know. Oh, it says, if you look at the Irradiate card, it says unless, if it doesn't meltdown, then do Unseen Agony.
Oh, otherwise, okay, so the card says it. It's not always. Okay. Alright, that's what I wanted to check.
So it's whenever Irradiate happens, but you said Irradiate's going to happen every turn.
So the first meltdown happens, then that move goes out of play.
Oh, okay.
Sure. First turn.
Yeah. Crisis Crater. The Dragon King drops its massive foot. The ground shifts violently. All survivors in the smash zone, which is none of us, it's 3 spaces around him, gain a -1 accuracy token, suffer bash, and +1 and 2 damage to 2 hit locations. Then perform basic action.
Basic action. Random threat in range.
That's all of us. So, you roll your random die.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Who's who?
Reroll. So you are always these two. Twitch is red, and I'm green over here.
All right, so yellow will be pancakes. And
that's what
be
I figured.
Red.
Reroll again.
Pancakes.
Yeah.
Yay!
That's actually very good. And what is his basic action?
His basic action is a speed of 2. Accuracy 2 plus.
Nope, speed of 3.
Speed of 3. You were correct. I get a +1 evasion token in the showdown.
So it is a speed of 2, normally 3, because of our defiling his temple. Accuracy of 2 plus, and it's going to do 3 damage. Move and attack. So I'm going to move him all up in your grill. Jesus, that's a big mini. That's got to be terrifying.
Yeah, all right, so 3. I have 1 natural evasion, 1 token, plus 2 evasion for my gear. So it's 4, so it's 6 plus hits.
6 plus hits.
What are we planning on how to play this week? It's called Tokaido?
Tokaido?
No. Or is it the other one?
The other. The panda-eating game.
Panda-eating game.
I'm going to spend the survival to dodge the one hit.
Okay, so he missed on two of them, and the one that he hit, he's going to dodge. And then it says, perform a radiate.
All right, you're right. The chest sphincter tugs open. The monster gains a minus one toughness.
Minus one toughness.
And then we do over...
If it has five or more toughness tokens, it doesn't otherwise perform unseen agony.
We're going to unseen agony.
All survivors.
That's it.
Yeah. In the blast zone, suffer one damage for each minus one token to a random hit location. So you need to roll one hit location.
Twitch proxy, you need to roll a hit location die. The monster is going to do one damage to a random hit location. I'm sorry, two damage.
No.
It's got a plus one. Oh, no, because it's...
It's not an attack.
Yeah, okay.
It's just a...
Okay, so who's rolling the hit location die, TP?
Nicholas Patton, please roll the hit location. Gamergram says Tokaido is a great one, but the panda one is Takenoko.
Yeah, Takenoko is the one we're doing.
Jersitter says, I've heard Tokaido is a lot of fun. What night do you guys do that? So we have both.
Tokaido sounds familiar.
We have both.
We have both. Tokaido is the one that Golden Distribution gave us. It's a traveling game, it's called. It's a little lighthearted game. We travel Japan and stuff.
Huh.
We haven't played either of them.
We can do Takenoko this week and Tokaido next week. And we can
compare
them.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Might have something else planned for next week. We'll see.
Well, we're definitely doing Takenoko this week, and that's on Thursdays at 8 p.m.
So each Thursday we do a different game. Every week we show how to play it. We play with Twitch chat.
Go over the rules,
and do all that. And then every Tuesday we do our Kingdom Death stream.
Every Monday.
Monday we just started our Spotlight stream, which shows off a new game that
currently released on Kickstarter or some other different media. It's for newly released games that we're trying to draw attention to.
Developers, things like that. Yeah. Stuff that people may not have seen yet and might want to.
And then every Saturday we do our Pathfinder stream where we...
And we are officially... On the 24th, we are officially doing the... I'm sorry, you said Pathfinder stream.
Right? Yeah.
24th?
The 24th of October. 2 weeks. On Monday.
Mm-hmm.
We're officially doing the Presidential Night Fight Kickstarter.
Okay, I was very confused as to why she was bringing up that date.
Yeah, I thought that was the MegaCon date.
Okay, so do you have your hit location?
Hit location is going to be body.
So take one damage to your body.
Okay.
Did you update your armor and everything?
I did not, no. What
you should
have
two armor at each hit location.
That's what I got. And how much damage am I taking?
One.
So I still have one... one on my body.
Correct.
And let's see...
See what?
Valjean Skin says, I'm a big sponsor of that. Yes, you are. Yes, he is. Of
the Spotlights.
Yeah.
And do you guys have Lords of Waterdeep yet?
No, we do not have that yet. Who's that, Kaelin?
Kaelin, yes.
Yes.
Okay, so it is now our turn finding the He does a lot of stuff.
Because he has his mood in play.
Yeah. Okay, so it's our turn. I'm going to attempt to shoot him with the Clawhead Arrow. Which is an accuracy of 6.
So you need to move closer.
That's fine. I can move closer. Okay, I'll move there.
Okay.
And that is a speed of 1. Accuracy of 6+. I have 1 natural accuracy, so it's an accuracy of 5+. I missed.
Can I shoot again?
Yeah, sure, why not? I'm going to spend a survival. Let me roll to see if I get my survival back and go to max survival. Matt survival. Okay, so I'm at 4. And I'm going
to...
I'm going to shoot my Vespertine Arrow now. Just because why not? I'm going to go for the crit. So,
a second, before you do that.
Why? Are you going to search the hit location deck?
He's going to use his turn.
That's fine. That's fine. So this is also an accuracy of 5+. Really? Come on!
I'm hitting the table because you're messing up the...
Okay, sorry. I rolled 2 4s.
2 4s.
What the...
You get nothing good, sir.
Oh my god. Okay, go ahead, Josh.
Okay.
That was sad.
So blue is my one guy. I'll have him attack with
hmm.
hit with a spear. Accuracy is a 6 plus.
That's so weird. I'm trying to update the Twitch hand.
Yes.
And the configurations are messing with the Twitch proxy cam. Like, I have it up, and I'm going to configure video, and it's, like, adjusting the Twitch proxy cam.
I'll call that in a minute and look at it.
You're attacking the Serpent Tail Vertebra. This is super dense.
What's his toughness?
Toughness is a 10. A 13, I'm sorry. 13.
13?
Oh, this is bad.
He has 1 natural strength. The weapon is 3 strength. So
he also has a minus 1 toughness token.
Alright. So
I'm sorry, what was that?
An 8 plus?
You were hit with the CHA.
CHA.
Clawhead arrow.
Oh,
it missed.
Barely ever. I didn't hit with it.
No.
Nope. Turn the monster to face away from the attacker. The Dragon King sweeps its tail.
You're gonna get blind spot.
He's gonna poop on you. Roll 1d10 and add your courage.
5.
You suffer bash and 2 damage to the legs. Bash
so
is knocked down.
Armor.
Correct.
Knocked
down. You attack with not pancakes.
Not pancakes. Damn it.
Okay.
If Twitch wants to go next...
I'm going
to
encourage you up.
Alright, okay. Yeah, you can do that. It's fine.
Oh, really? And you get up.
I get up. I want to dash away. No, I'll dash later if I need it.
So, Twitch, it is now your turn. You have the Zambato that you can attack with. It auto-hits...
What's the speed on? It's a slow weapon, so it's 1.
Yeah.
But they also have the guitar, which I think is stronger.
Is the guitar stronger?
Yes.
But it doesn't have devastating. Stronger. Oh, but
they don't have devastating anyways. They have the Zombato has deadly, and the Zombato is also frail, and the first thing I hit was a super dense card.
Yeah. So actually, yeah, the digging claw guitar might be better. It's a lot better. It's slightly weaker. It's a 5 strength instead of 6, but it's a 4 plus accuracy.
Yeah.
So it's really good.
Oh, they auto hit.
They auto hit with it.
Oh, good thing.
Yeah, super dense. So you would have broke the Zambato already. Is it the same card? Did you put it back?
No. Serpent Tail.
It does the same thing.
It's very similar.
Yeah. So Twitch Proxy, I need you to roll a d10 for the wound check. Now, you have... What's your strength? You have 3 strength. The weapon has 5. So you have 8 total strength. He's got a minus 1 toughness token.
Let's make that a 9 out of 13.
So yeah, you need to roll a 4 plus.
4 plus.
Hmm. 4 plus wounds the monster. So who's rolling for us, Twitch Proxy? You haven't got there yet.
And Loyal
Symbol is an
8.
Oh, okay. You don't have any plus luck, right?
I don't think they have that. Yeah. 2.
Not 2. Okay, so an 8, that is a wound.
Okay.
Now, this is the opposite. The other one was a failure. This is a wound.
Oh.
So, turn the monster to face away from the attacker. It happens anyways. Roll a d10. Twitch Proxy needs you to roll a d10 and add your courage to the result.
Okay, we have 1 courage. So, Cage, if you could roll a d10 for us, please.
This is very annoying.
Cage rolled a 2, so that's a total of 3.
Okay, so you are knocked down, and you take 2 damage to your legs.
Okay, 2 damage, which means that we have no more armor on our legs.
Now, do you want to encourage them up so they could possibly attack again? Jurisher? And make sure you give them a wound.
Yeah, I give them a wound.
Okay.
I'll have Reinhardt.
Okay, so you are encouraged in standing back up, Twitch Proxy. Would you like to spend the survival and attack again?
Remember, you have the riot armor, so you might not spend it.
Right. You have a 50-50 shot of not spending it.
Josh, stop rubbing your face.
Hi.
Are you paying attention to us at all? Okay.
No,
so, I think we should... We have 5. I was trying to zoom in so I can see you guys a little bit better. We have 5. I think that we should totally spend it. What do you think?
And it's a 50-50 shot of you not spending it because of your... So we need you to roll a d10 to see if you spend it or not.
Can you see if we spend that, please?
Fitty. Because it seems like the way to get the Dragon King...
Rolled a 9, so we don't even spend it.
Don't even spend it.
Okay, so now what?
You attack again, you auto-hit.
Okay.
I don't know what this is. Microwave heart.
So?
It performs a radiate.
That's not yet. That's a reflux. They get the wound still.
Okay. So, we need you to roll a d10.
Just one?
Just one. And this is going to be a wound check. 4+ does a wound.
For anyone just joining us, you can join the queue at any time, exclamation point join. When it is your turn to roll, I'll let you know. It's really easy commands like exclamation point roll d10 to roll a d10. It's Nicholas Patton's turn. Nicholas, if you could please roll that d10 for us. Kate says, let's DPS this thing into the ground before we all die.
That's agreed. Do you know what that means?
No.
Damage per second, DPS, so perform as much damage as quickly as possible.
Gotcha.
So what's the next D10?
The next D, waiting for Nicholas Patton to roll, I'm going to give him another second or two, and then I'm going to move to the next, Nicholas rolled 10!
Oh, okay.
Is that crit?
No.
Crit location. That's, yeah, it figures as a non-crit location. So you wounded him, but now he performs radiate. Irradiate.
He gains a minus one toughness token.
Is that like, irregardless?
Yeah. So he gets another minus one toughness token, so he's got two, and then he's going to perform Unseen Agony.
So Unseen Agony, everyone suffers two damage to a random hit location besides Matt.
Twitch proxy?
Yes.
I need you to roll a random or a hit location die, and you're going to suffer two damage to that location.
Okay, Loyal Sim, if you can roll an HL for me, please. Exclamation point, roll HL. And you're paying attention to the fighting arts that I have, right?
Not at all. I don't know what you have.
Burn focus does not matter. Plus one evasion token on first crit.
Okay, you didn't crit.
Threat when knocked down.
You're not knocked down.
And then vermin, whatever vermin is.
There's no vermin on the board.
So it doesn't matter. I should have been knocked down when they got knocked down.
Loyalson rolled body, so that's two to the body.
I'm overprotective. Whenever adjacent survivor gets knocked down. The
pancake.
Stop talking to Matt and talk to the crowd. I hit its body, and I only have one armor there, so now I have
and
light damage.
Okay.
So would Twitch like to encourage me up so I can do something?
We have to use a survivor, or do we...
You use a survival, but you roll to see if you use it or not.
You roll to see if we use a survival, let's do it. So...
Again, we're trying to do as much damage as quickly as possible to him.
Cage rolled a 6. Does that mean we do not use
you
it?
You don't use it.
Okay, awesome.
I get to look at the top.
The whole card is not following you. Thank you so much to the whole card for following us. We really appreciate it.
Gracias.
Mark, Matt's daddy, totally missed you.
What?
He said, did anyone who missed me, so.
Oh. What are you reading?
I get to see the next AR card.
Okay, yeah.
So I'm just looking to see what it was. It's here's the question.
Here is the question.
Can you stand my character up?
I can certainly try.
Or I can spend my action to put my shield up, dart out of the way so he tries to attack me.
And pull him out of your
and
zone.
And just try
of
to pull everyone
else.
Kind of out of the zone of everyone else.
That's not bad. I like it.
So if I move 7, I can move 7 spaces. I have movement of 6, and then I have my leather boots that I can move 1 extra space at the end of my action.
That's the very end of the edge of the board.
And if... What's his range on this thing?
The radiate's only 3 spaces.
3 spaces. So if he's at the end...
He won't be able to hit anyone.
I just want to see, can you move him to the end real quick? He's right here. This corner. So he's just kind of out of range. I can move back 1 space. Just to keep him closer to you guys.
Okay.
So yeah, move me down.
To here?
Yeah, to there.
And he would be...
Put him right here, though.
Yeah, he's not there yet.
Because it's not guaranteed that...
Right, so you throw up your shield, and now it is the monster's turn.
It's monster's turn. Reinhardt is monster controller. Random threat in range.
Boop.
It's not guaranteed.
So we're all in range.
Yeah.
So.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Gotcha. It's going to be.
Insanity.
What's its nuts? What's the name again?
Reinhardt.
Reinhardt.
Four speed.
Oh boy, that's with the plus one?
Yep.
Okay. Boar speed, accuracy of?
2+.
Does he have any evasion?
Nope.
Oh, Reinhardt's gonna die.
No!
Damage of?
3 damage each, but that's with the plus one damage.
Whew. Really, no evasion?
I wish I had just one.
Even, no, 2, you would have dodged everything.
Oh, 2, yeah, I would have dodged everything, but nope, I don't dodge anything.
That's terrible.
So I get 4 hits.
Are you going to dodge any of them?
I can do that after all my...
No.
For 3 damage each.
I think you're going to want to dodge the head.
I'll dodge the head.
Josh is going to roll some severe injuries, guys.
I am knocked down because of my heavy injury.
But you'll get up again?
On the body, and I got to roll that. So let's roll that one first. 9.
On the body?
Yes.
Collapse lung. Gain -1 movement token and 1 breathing bleeding token. Not a breathing token.
I thought you said breathing token.
Ew. And any other severe injuries?
Probably. Hand. 3 damage. Nope. None on the hand. Just knocked down.
4 damage, no? Oh, no. 3 damage.
And the waist is just a headache.
Okay. So only the 1 severe injury. That's not fun.
That sucked.
And does he do anything else?
He's gonna get a -1 token! There's 3! Does Twitch want to dash out of the way before this happens? Because they can.
Yeah.
So
they can just move straight backwards.
Yeah.
That's handy. It's the handy dandy notebook.
Duxon has joined the queue.
Oh, you should have done this twice. Gotta let
her. You ruined it!
So oh.
What are we doing?
Just dashing out of the way. The monster is now going.
Did you roll
a d10? Roll
a
d10? Okay.
Yeah. And just see if you use your survival or not.
Yeah, so if it's a 6+, you don't use your survival.
If not, -1. Alright. Monster's gonna do.
Irradiate.
He has 3 tokens on.
He's going to do 3 damage to everyone. To him.
Just Reinhardt, which is to the body.
The whole card is now hosting us.
I rolled a 2.
Instant death! The blow sends a bone fragment directly into your heart, killing you instantly. Reinhardt is dead.
Oh, okay. Mr. Frightful rolled a 6, so we do not use one of our 5 survival.
You want to put that up on the board?
Yeah.
And Reinhardt is dead.
Yay!
I love that table. Corgan loves you. That's the username.
That's interesting. Okay, so it is our turn now?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to shoot him with the bow. Yay.
Do you want Twitch to attack first?
No.
Why?
Because if there's a reaction, I don't want him to go off and do a blast. That's going to hurt Twitch.
But if he runs up to attack you, will they be out of range?
They would use their dash. No, I don't believe they would be. He would be here. So he is 4 spaces big. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And they would be 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, he would be out of range by 1. So I could always move forward by 1 space, and now they won't be out of range.
Okay, that's fine. That's all I'm trying to keep into.
That's fine. That makes sense.
That's my logic there.
So I'm going to roll 3 dice. It is a...
There's a lot of dice saviors of... Oops.
Survivors. 5+ accuracy. Two hits. One of them's perfect, but I don't get anything for that, unfortunately. I don't think. Do I?
I don't think you get anything perfect.
No. Okay, so I hit 2 hit locations. You're making a mess, Josh.
Gorgon Loves You says, we just started our People of the Sun game last night. And
ooh.
Dangerous and new ways.
Very cool. And I'm attacking the Serpent Horns, which are impervious, and the Serpent Thigh. It's a reflex. Let me do this one first.
Disorder.
Doesn't make sense not to do that one first. And I have Deadly. So a 9-10. We'll crit. A 3. Okay. So I get a random disorder. I am
insane?
Not insane. I get a disorder.
Oh, did you guys have
Quixotic.
Quixotic.
Twitch proxy, is your fighting art quixotic?
No, it's burn
disorder.
Focus and
disorder. Disorder.
Disorder is delicious and vermin.
Oh, no, it was
someone else. I got unlucky. You cannot crit. I hate you. I hate you. Why would you suck so much with the guy with the crit bow?
I'm sorry.
I grabbed my own disorder.
You shouldn't be grabbing them for me.
Do you want to grab your own disorder?
Yes.
All the grabbing of things. What's our threshold for running away?
We can't run away anymore. That we don't actually have that.
What do you mean we don't have it? Didn't you?
No.
We, remember we went back and said, oh, we weren't supposed to be able to do that?
Oh, because you saw that it was in the thing?
I thought I saw it. It was in the possible cards we can get.
Wait, we're delicious. We are delicious. We are a threat when knocked down.
I'm gonna.
So no running away for us all. Look,
I'm gonna spend
many,
a survival to
how
go again.
How many of the saviors are in here right now?
Two.
Or two Aegis ones.
Great. And.
Which back the Dragon King? Where's Zenith? He
three
should
hits.
Be here for this.
Yeah, where is Zenith?
This is baby.
Gorgon loves you. You're running away is an innovation
I
that
the trap card.
Josh
no.
thought
no.
we had.
No,
turns
no.
out we don't. It's all his fault. It's rule number three.
Performer Radiate. It's impervious.
First strike, impervious. Okay.
Performer Radiate.
No one's there.
He gets a minus one toughness token, though.
Sure.
Which is actually good.
So next turn he's going to do his...
Implosion.
His implosion.
I'm attacking his bony chest sphincter.
Bony chest sphincter.
I'm not doing that.
The butt
that.
Of the chest? Just remember, you can't crit anymore.
Oh. Oh, this is good. If I wound this one, he loses all negative toughness tokens.
Okay. So he's minus four toughness, so it's a nine. That's a wound.
Did it?
Okay, so he takes a wound, and he also loses all of his toughness tokens. However, he is plus four toughness until the end of the round.
So... he's going to be a bitch to wound. Why,
yeah.
What's the next one do?
Bony chest sphincter. If I wound him, he full moves. He doesn't like to be touched, so he full moves towards me and throws me, and I'm placed them in a knockdown an unoccupied corner of the showdown board. So he throws me to the corner of the showdown board if I were to wound him, which I can now only do if I roll a 10. Can't crit. I just roll a 10.
Okay. That's for your natural true strength.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think. But either way, it's a 2, so I don't do it. So he's fine. I don't wound his bony chest sphincter.
All right.
But I got rid of his minus toughness tokens.
That's all that matters.
Twitch proxy, you could go now, but he's got plus four toughness.
So
he's got 17 toughness.
What does that mean as far as?
Your weapon does, what's the bottom number on your weapon?
Nothing.
The Qatar?
Six.
So six.
No, wait, that's the Zabato.
Yeah, what's the Qatar?
I don't
know
the
Qatar. Yes,
no,
you do. The digging thing.
The digging claw? Five.
Yeah. Five, you have how many strength?
Strength is
three.
Three.
So that's eight, so you would need to roll a
nine
or ten to wound it.
What is the benefit of waiting and trying not to do it?
He loses the minus four toughness tokens next turn.
But there's no harm in trying and failing, right?
If
you burn through his
hit
location decks, and he could either hit you with a reaction, or you can get a trap card.
All right, then let's skip it.
Is there anything else they can do on their turn?
They can check the top two A cards.
Mm-hmm.
Because they have a throw-headed Ben. 1-2 punch.
I will be right back.
Where are you going?
Restroom.
He needs
potty break.
Yep.
So what are the top two cards?
There's two of them there.
Yes, the top two cards are two cards.
There's 1-2 punch, and then there's rough smack.
Rough smack. And do you want to describe what they do?
1-2 punch is actually two attacks. First, there would be a speed of 3 each because he has a plus 1 speed token. A damage of 2. And then after the first hit, if target's still a threat, the dragon keeps attacking. It's going to attack the closest facing in range, which would be Matt. And he's not very kinky. So I think Rough Smack is furthest threat in range, which is actually me, the tank. And then it's a speed of 4, but I have a punch of evasion, and I can throw my shield up. And then he tries to do bash and knockback, but...
Mr. Breakfast says, does he get negative 2 toughness?
Negative 2 toughness?
So he says.
No. He's no negative toughness. So what Matt did was he hit a hit location card that got rid of all the minus toughness tokens, which is good because he's just about to do meltdown. I don't know if those are the best thing.
Oh, they're talking about Matt. Oh. Maybe? That's okay. Dexon says only if he uses trope.
So I'm going to do the rough smack just so I get hit. So I'm going to put my shield up where I'm at.
He
meant that. Sorry. And I'm thinking. Okay. So he comes up to me. He's gonna do a speed of 4. I have 4 evasion, so 6 plus hits. 2 hits. I have a shield to block 1. And the last one I will dodge. So it doesn't do anything. He tries to do bash, but I ignore bash because I have the leather armor set. And I get knocked back 20. So can you move my guy just like back one spot?
To the end?
Yeah, that's
okay.
All that you can really do. Actually... Oh, whatever. So I do that now. And now he's going to get a minus 1 toughness token. And I suffer 1 damage to my wrist. It's our turn. So now... You guys can attack him.
And what do we have to do to attack him?
Just gonna move up to him, and you can hit him in the butt.
And what do we roll? Do we auto-hit still?
You auto-hit still, so you don't have to roll anything to hit.
Okay.
It's just to see if you wound or not.
And so it's an exclamation point.
D10.
Next one.
So 12, you have toughness of 5 of the weapon, plus 3.
So Nicholas Patton, if you could please roll a D10 for us, and anyone just joining, you can join our queue at any time to roll dice and try to hit the monster for us.
So... 4 plus wood wound.
Talking. Just exclamation point join, and you can join and play with us. So if it's a 4 plus to rune, Nicholas, as long as you roll a 4 or higher, we shouldn't have a problem with that, please. We've been actually doing some pretty good rolls today. I have not used a single survival. Nicholas rolled a 10. We can't crit, you said. Can we crit?
Yeah, you can crit.
We critted. It's a 10, right?
That's awesome. You are... invigorated by the resounding sound of your blow. Gain a plus 1 strength token.
Woo-hoo! We just crit.
Oh, you can spend 2 survival.
Do it.
I get plus 1 evasion on first crit.
Do you have any heavy gear? That's the only thing about that. If you have any heavy gear.
Okay. Zambato's heavy, I believe.
Oh, yeah. So you can't, you don't get that.
Why did you give me that?
But you guys can spend 2 survival.
Uh-huh. And?
Get 1 plus 1 permanent strength.
Instead
of the token.
Permanent strength?
Yes. So spend 2 survival.
Do it.
Do we get a roll to see if we use
no.
it? No. Okay. We have 5. Let's do it.
Yeah.
So that puts our survival down to 3. And we get a plus 1 permanent strength, which puts our permanent strength from 3 to 4.
Oh,
we are a badass panda panda.
And it's just going to go up because they're a red savior.
Yep.
After this fight, it's going
to
go up.
Yeah. So you guys can go ahead and roll to see if you use another action and surge and try to hit again.
Do it.
If you want.
Do it.
Yeah, so we're going to roll to see if we use that D10. I mean, if we use a survivor? Survival?
Survival.
So Loyal Sim, if you can roll that D10 for us, please. Gorgon loves you, says no Zambato shaming. Sorry.
Zambato is awesome. It's just...
Zambato is awesome.
I mean, fair enough. But how can I have a problem with
no.
plus 1 strength permanent?
I can't do that. Okay.
Not on the mic.
Cheater, pumpkin eater.
You're a pumpkin eater. You eat pumpkins.
I do eat pumpkins. Pumpkin pie specifically is delicious.
Pumpkin spice latte.
Oh my god, I got a pumpkin spice latte. Do we have Loyal Sim rolled a 10, so we damn it, it's not a critical thing. We do not use our survival and we hit again.
One hit.
Wait, why do we hit? Oh,
right.
It's auto hit.
It's auto hit.
So go ahead. You're going to roll a d10 for the strength check, and what is the monster's toughness right now?
Minus one.
Do you think we can roll 12?
3 plus.
Cage rolled a 10, and it's 3 tens in a row. No?
It's not a crit location.
No! I mean, at least we...
It's a wound.
It's a wound.
And then he performs a radiate, so he's going to get another minus one toughness token, and he's going to then poop on everyone around him.
Literally?
So, roll hit location damage, and you get 2 damage to...
A hit location?
Yeah, roll a hit location, and you're going to get 2 damage to that location.
I take 2 damage to the head.
Okay.
Ouch.
So, Duxton, if you can roll an HL, exclamation point, roll HL, that'll tell us where we get damage. We currently do not have any armor to our legs or our body, but we have 2 armor everywhere else.
Actually, this is pretty good for this, because every time I get a severe injury, every time I ignore one, I can get I get a disorder. Mm-hmm. So I can get rid of the unlucky fairly easily.
Yeah, fairly easily. You have to get hit, though.
Yeah.
And you can also use drums to try to get rid of it, too.
Ah.
What are you doing, Matt, while they're figuring out where they get hit?
I'm going to attack with my bow. And my range is 5.
Gorgon Loves You has joined our queue. Awesome. I'm going to give Duck the World Body. Okay. That means that we... How many damage are we supposed
to
take there? 2. Oh, we already had a light wound.
So you have to roll in the severe injury table.
So you're knocked down.
Oh, this is...
And I am a threat when we are knocked down.
Yeah, I know. So you need someone to roll d10.
Oh, you better hope for a high roll.
And we just wasted all of our 10s. Mr. Frightful, please roll high. Save Panda Panda. I have a kinship with Panda Panda because it's Panda. And I love pandas. Mr. Frightful rolled a 4.
Gaping chest wound. Suffer minus 1 permanent strength.
Okay, I can do that.
Okay,
I
so
mean, fair enough.
That was a wash. And a bleeding token.
I mean, it could have ended a lot worse than that.
Yeah, could have been a lot worse.
I'll check on the bag. Gasping check.
Gaping.
Gaping chest wound. Because you can't possibly cure that.
Yeah.
And get your strength back.
Yeah.
Ooh, okay.
So there's a little checkbox
right
there.
So let's see, gaping chest wound. Now, would you remember that means if I ever do that would give me a chance back?
That's why I'm asking you to check the box. And you get a bleed token.
One hit. And I'm attacking the serpent foot. And he has a toughness of minus 2 right now?
Yes.
So he has a toughness of 11. This weapon has 6. I have 2, so that's 8, so I need 3 plus. That's a wound.
It's a wound.
I'm going to spend a survival. I'm going to see if I spend a survival. I don't. I actually gain a survival.
Gain a survival for trying to use a survival.
That's the greatest thing ever.
It's such an awesome fighting art.
And I'm going to attack again. I'm probably going to hit the trap card here with my luck. It's got a lot of cards, though. 1 hit. Ugh. Okay, so a 3 wounds. That's a wound. And he's going to irradiate, so give him a minus 1 toughness token. Twitch proxy, I need you to roll another hit location.
No, don't do this!
3 damage to my feet.
1 hit location, you say?
Yep.
Okay, Nicholas, if you can roll that hit location for us. And what else am I trying to do?
This guy, yeah, I can see why you want a bunch of bows up against him. Right?
Yep. So he's minus 3 toughness, so it's a 10, right?
Yeah. Come after me, Meanie.
That is another body.
So you need to roll another severe injury for the body.
Please don't kill me, guys.
Panda's gonna die.
Loyal Sim, if you could please roll D10 for us, please.
I'm just gonna say RIP to Panda here.
Please don't.
I got a feeling that tonight's going to be a good night.
No! Have faith in us! We've been doing so well, and Panda's such a great character.
Panda.
Survivor.
Panda.
Do the panda chant. Panda. Loyal Sim. 6!
6. Disemboweled. Your movement is reduced to 1 until the showdown ends.
Okay, so that's not permanent, right?
No, it's
good. Gain a bleeding token. You must skip the next hunt.
Okay,
so mark that box.
Fair enough. Okay.
Kind of want to draw the monster away from.
Do I have to do anything?
You can't do anything right now,
I mean,
so.
Do I have to
check the skip next hunt box?
But do I have to do anything as far as removing some movement or everything's?
It's your one movement right now.
Okay, I don't have to check the disembowelment.
Nah, you're fine. How much health does he have left?
6.
Ouch.
So
possibly next turn.
I'm just trying to think what I want to do.
I really should lure him away from Panda Panda.
How much bleed is Panda up to? That's 2, I believe.
2
right?
bleeds.
Yeah, you're
yeah.
fine
2
on
out
the bleeds.
Of 5. So far, please don't say that.
What are you going to do, Josh?
I can't do that right now.
You want to trip him?
That's what I was looking at.
Josh.
What?
It's already hard enough to hear you without you talking into your mouth. And talking into your hand.
Alright.
Talking into your mouth.
Talking into
so,
your
mouth. This is what I'm thinking.
What are you thinking?
I could kind of like try to dash to the other side and try to lure him away for his next attack.
That's what I would recommend. It might be a random and then you'd be kind of screwed, but.
Oh, yeah,
I
don't know what's next.
I think that would be beneficial, though.
Chunky monkey?
But I could also try to hit him with my axe first and then run. Because I have a reach with my axe.
But he might have an irradiate thing next. And then they're going to get hit for 4 damage.
Alright. They keep getting bodies. Only one severe injury roll, though. Alright, so. Can you move me 7
what,
spaces?
Who, pancake?
Yeah, pancakes. That way, 7
1,
spaces.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay.
Is that far? That's far enough, right?
Yeah, it should be.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay, so now it is the monster's turn.
Your monster control.
Okay. And what is he doing? Get me?
I thought I looked up. Oh, then we got rid of that card.
Closest threat in range.
That's them. That was my worry.
Yeah. Probably gonna die. Even though they're in the blind spot, because it's a field of view, right?
Yeah.
Harumph. Okay, so you're probably gonna die here, Panda Panda.
No!
Yeah, just putting that out there.
Yeah, they could maybe live. They have plus 20 vision. My gear.
So, speed of 3, accuracy of 3 plus?
3 plus.
You have just 1 evasion?
Yeah. Rahai Gear has 1 evasion built into it.
They don't have 1.
Do you have any
natural evasion?
Evasion?
No.
So
2 hits for 3 damage each. I need you to roll 2 hit locations.
Okay, if they're like a head and arms or the waist or something, they should be fine, right?
He's
3 damage.
That's not it, though.
No, that's not it.
Oh.
Then he's going to irradiate.
Twice.
Why don't you
down.
Save me?
Twice?
Perform irradiate. At the end of the monster turn, perform irradiate.
Oh, God.
Okay, so how many dice are we rolling?
2 hit location dice.
So if Cage rolled arms, so that's good. So that gives us a light damage on the arms, right?
3 damage to your arms.
So I already had 2.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
And then Duxton, if you could roll an HL for us, please.
Now, keep
sure
in mind,
still
you still have a
dodge
that you could do.
Can we do that now?
Well, see
you
what,
see
what, see
what
you
roll.
Roll.
See what they roll. Yeah.
Okay, I didn't know if that's a thing.
Yeah, you could. That's the
so
nice
you
thing.
See both rolls, and they say, "All right, I want to dodge this hit out of the two."
Okay, so. Well, I definitely want to take the arms.
Yeah, that's a given.
And head, so I'll take that too, right?
Nah, yeah, you might as well.
I mean, because I can always dodge next time.
Yeah, it's not
but
gonna make
now
it.
I have the control of saying that I can
yeah.
take it on an armored spot versus getting something later
that's,
and not having armor.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
You're just going to take a ton of damage now.
Yeah, you're going to take a buttload of damage now.
So does that mean I have a head damage?
Heavy head injury, yes.
Yeah. Does anything happen with that?
No.
You
get knocked down.
You get knocked down, but you're already knocked down.
Can I only dodge once?
Yeah.
Once per turn.
Okay, so I can dodge later in this turn, is what you were saying. Okay.
Well, you can't dodge the next two hits. The thing is, they're going to do 4 or 5 damage, so...
So maybe I should dodge the head, because...
It's not going to make
They're
going to
do 4 or 5 damage, you're going to get spear injury anyway. It really doesn't matter.
But if I... Then I'll have, also have that armor later on. If
you get hit in the head now, it's going to get rid of it anyway.
You might as well.
Dodge
yeah.
it?
Yeah, dodge it. Go ahead. You got to roll to spend
we'll
a
We'll see
survival.
If you use the spend survival.
Okay.
And then while you're at that, after you pull that person, pull the next person to roll a hit location
Oregon
die.
Oregon loves you. If you could please roll a d10. It's exclamation point roll d10. And then we're pulling another person to roll a hit location?
Yeah. So he's going to irradiate twice. So he's going to do...
Mr. Freifel, if you could roll a hit location for us,
down.
Please.
Oh, Jesus.
And he's going to get plus 1 health.
We got this. We're going to be fine.
This is going to get discarded, so he won't do irradiate.
Positively.
Which is nice.
Yeah.
So Gorgon loves you rolled ahead, so I'm kind of glad that I didn't know.
No, that doesn't make a difference then. So it was a waste then.
And...
So you're going to take 4 damage to your head.
Oh.
And what?
No, that's... Sorry, that was... No, Gorgon, you were right.
What?
Oh.
Who was rolling d10?
So Gorgon rolled ahead, and then rolled a 5, and then Mr. Pfeiffer rolled arms. And it was supposed to be swapped, but can I just use the 5 and then arms?
Sure.
Whatever.
Okay.
Doesn't make a difference. You still have to roll a severe arm injury.
All right. Sorry. I wasn't clear, guys. I'm sorry about that. So we're gonna take the 5 and.
So you use a survival.
So we do use a survival.
Yeah.
And then you have to roll a severe arm injury. So I need you to roll a d10.
Severe arm injury. Roll a d10. Okay. If I make it out of here alive, I'm gonna be very damaged. Nicholas Patton, if you could roll a d10 for us, please.
Panda. I wonder what they're going to get.
Huh?
This is exciting. I wonder what they're going to get. They're going to get an arm ripped off. They're just going to get knocked down.
2.
You die of shock. Your vision fades, along with the sight of your mangled, armless torso.
Panda.
Panda's dead. That was a waste of a good savior.
That was a great savior. It was much.
Not that great, apparently.
This is why no one likes you. All
right. He's gonna form.
Irradiate again.
So he gets another -5 toughness tokens. We do meltdown.
How much HP is left on the Dragon King?
Oh my. I'm about to get F'd in the A right now.
Wow.
7 health.
7 health?
The Dragon King's nuclear heart explodes with an ear-shattering whine. Everything in the monster's path burns up in the wave of unseen heat. Is there anything in its blind spot?
No.
Oh, we have 2 dead survivors.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Forgot about that. So you're fine back there.
Yeah, I'm fine back there.
This half of the board is completely destroyed. Each survivor in the meltdown zone is caught in the disintegrating wave. I roll a d10.
He's going to try to have you dodge out of the way, but...
There's no point.
You don't have enough movement to do it.
No, I don't.
You got so close to it, but you...
All survivors and blind spots suffer 1 damage for each -1 toughness token.
So it's 5.
Oh, so wait. I do that first, and then this happens. Caught in a disintegrating wave. So all survivors in the King's Field, Dragon King's Field of View in blind spot suffer 1 damage. So I suffer 5 damage.
To a random
hit location. To 1 hit location.
Cage says he died like hope, armless and alone. Is it too soon? Dexon says, I just noticed the gear grid for TP, no use for the affinities. Dexon says, I just noticed the gear grid for TP, no use for the affinities.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
5 on the head. Intracranial hemorrhage, you can no longer use or gain any survival.
You have your ability.
What about it?
Ignore 1 severe injury.
Oh, yeah. I guess I'll ignore that. Give me a disorder.
If that's up to you.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, I want to... That's a bad one.
It's a bad one.
I mean, I'm not dead, but...
But you're dead?
But you're a chance of actually winning this.
Yeah. Post-traumatic stress. Next settlement phase, you do not contribute or participate in any endeavors. Skip the next hunt to recover. So this goes away after one turn?
Pretty much.
That's annoying.
I mean, it stays in your sheet, but like...
Forever?
Yeah, but it's just like the next hunt you just...
Oh, it's always skip the next hunt?
No, it's just like the next hunt it happens. It doesn't say it cures you, it just says...
But do I erase it after the next hunt?
I don't think you do. I think you just skip the next hunt and you just don't do anything.
Then I roll a d10.
Nine.
So close. Knockback 7, archive any soluble gear. I don't have any soluble gear.
And then this and this.
Oh, technically I was here.
You were here. You were next to the pillar. And this all gets destroyed anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. So Lightning says, still lasted longer than Harambe versus a small child.
Aww.
Aww.
Then archive all destructible terrain tiles, flip all lava pool tiles to obsidian tower tiles. What does that do? What does that do? The Dragon King's protective chest sphincter screw shut. Remove all minus one toughness tokens.
Cage says, what happens on a 10, Matt?
A 10, I get the acrobatics fighting art, and that's it.
You can try to get iron from it.
No. Okay, so.
And if you have a heavy or club, you get to roll an extra d10. If you roll 16 plus, you also get plus one permanent strength.
I do not have any of those things. So. Josh, would you like to stand me up?
Yeah, I guess so.
Thanks. Nah, I'm close enough. You want to go first?
No, cool. Go for it.
I'm going to attack with the Vespertine Bow. It is 5 plus accuracy. 2 hits. Oh, Christ.
All survivors are doomed. Perform a basic action against the attacker.
Okay.
So it's 3 speed.
Yeah.
No evasion.
1 evasion.
So 3 plus.
I'm sorry, no, 2 evasion because I have
3
the...
Hits. For 3 damage each.
Okay. 3 hits for 3 damage each. 2 what? Hands, body. So I take a severe hand injury.
Where is the dragging card? AI cards?
Right here. Yeah, here. I die of shock. My vision fades along with the sight of my mangled, armless torso.
You also got this.
Interesting.
He punches you.
Into another dimension?
It sends you skyward into the air.
You are transported to an unfamiliar, terrifying world without sound or direction. So he punches me into another dimension. Temporarily. But I'm dead.
Huh. All right. And then he performs things. He gets a minus one toughness token.
Yes.
Who's that?
What?
Mark's here.
What the shit?
Oh.
I've been on the stream all around your area.
Hello, Mark.
Here's some quesadillas.
Those don't look like quesadillas.
It's a KFC, not Taco Bell.
It's a KFC Taco Bell.
KFC dia.
I'm hiding.
Mark's here.
Yeah, I was driving around.
Hey, Mark.
Hi.
Oh, we're about to die right now.
Oh, that's the perfect time to come walking.
Yeah, right.
It's all your fault, Mark.
So, Josh, it is. You're the only one left.
Yeah, I know. Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Aren't you the quesadilla guy?
I'm full. I ate way too much already.
There's quesadilla in there.
No, thank you.
KFC?
KFC?
Taco Bell. Taco Bell is KFC.
KFC-dia.
I was very confused of who the hell was at the door. I'm like, I'm looking, I'm like, I think that's Mark. Is that some of your defiled vile decks?
Yeah, these are some defiled vile decks for you.
Ah, the squished ones.
What did you do with them?
I ran them over.
Why are they sticky?
On purpose?
He defiled them in multiple
ways. Like the box during the other stream?
Huh?
What?
You don't remember defiling the box on the other stream? The box of evil Jesus Jedi?
I was not defiling it. I was just using it as a euphemism.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Joshua?
So get yourself killed, guys. Come on.
We're working on it.
So you're moving up closer. You're not going to be in range to attack him unless you dash.
Yeah, I'm going to dash. That's all I can do to try to...
You okay over there?
I got to log back into Twitch.
Cage says, I legit thought your crazy neighbor was coming over to kill you with the leaf blower.
Ah, the leaf blower.
So
we want to
go to the blind spot or do it in the, from the corner?
Blind spot. Do it.
Blind spot, okay. I got
to
go
yeah.
to the blind spot.
I think you're already in the blind spot.
No,
there you
no,
go.
I was
blind
in
spot.
The corner. All right, so I have a speed of 2, hit on a 5+.
Five. Oh, you suck.
Yep.
Try it again. Try it again.
Is Josh the only one alive?
Yes, he is the only one alive.
Wow. Josh, maybe.
Oh no! I plus 1 accuracy.
Ah,
so
you
one
hit.
Hit.
You hit one.
Josh,
yay.
Can we roll for you?
If you guys want to.
Yes.
You have been doing well with your rolls. You're in hitting the king's mouth. Yeah, sure. Reflex. That's gonna be fun. So his toughness is what right now?
He's minus 1 token.
So
he's 12.
How much strength do you have?
I have 4 natural strength, and my weapon has 4 strength.
So, 8.
So,
4+.
4+.
Wounds. 4+ wounds. Let me know what is rolled TP.
Want to turn that off?
I'm trying to.
What that is? The
ad? These freaking ads.
The ad? Yeah. No,
don't you have Prime? Didn't we go over this with you already?
That would mean I would actually have to do something. And spend time out of my busy day to do something.
Defiled, vile deck.
What was the roll?
I'm waiting for Loelson to roll. Mr. Frightful says, poke it in the butt. The best
he's attempting to.
I'm going to pull another person from the queue. I hate doing that to Loelson because she's so loyal.
Ha, it's in her name. Get it. Who next?
Cage, if you could roll for us, please. Oh, no, Loelson rolled a 3.
So that's a miss.
4.
It's a miss.
8. Yeah, miss. Okay.
The Dragon King's neck elongates and the head darts towards the attacker. Are you within 6 spaces?
Yes.
They suffer bleed 2 and archive all of their resources unless they spend 2 survival.
I have just 2 survival left to spend to do that.
Okay.
Well, Cage had rolled a 2, so.
Do you really care about your resources, though?
Oh, resources?
Yeah, resources.
I thought it was gear.
No, resources.
I don't have any resources.
So you get bleed 2.
So I just get bleed 2. That's fine.
Are you going to try to attack him again? This isn't going very well.
This is gonna, I can't hold my shield
TP.
Up then.
This is going to be a TPK right now.
I can't put up my shield if I surge.
Put up your shield then.
So.
Oh, you're the green savior.
Yeah, I'm the green savior.
So you might have a shot, actually.
Like, I have the best shot of this. So I'm not going to use my...
The Lordly Roar. Threat with most hunt XP. Yeah, that's you. The monster's roar propels a searing wind across your face.
I didn't say anything because I'm the only person left.
The sound quakes your bowels.
I got to poop.
That would be the Taco Bell.
So hold on, it's going to... that's a big mini.
Yes, it is a big mini.
That's not a mini, that's a maxi.
A maxi pad. You suffer 4 brain damage.
Oh, I have 9, so...
Roll a d10 and add your courage.
Twitch, roll a d10 for me.
It doesn't matter. What's your courage?
1.
Yeah, so it's going to be less than 12.
Okay.
Suffer the flea brain trauma and add 1 damage to your head. It says add... And 1 damage to your head hit location.
Okay, so I get damage to the head.
So you suffer the flea brain trauma. What the hell is that? You are knocked down and suffer knockback equal to your movement towards the closest board edge. Gain 1d5 insanity.
So that's
under 5. I'll just use that. So 3 insanity.
Yeah, that's good enough.
It's not bash, it's knocked down.
No, you're knocked down and then bash equal to your movement towards the closest board edge.
What? Is it?
Suffer knockback equal to your movement towards the closest board edge. Yeah. We've never had that one before.
Okay. That's it?
Yep.
Okay.
He just made you poop your pants and run away.
Did he actually get to run away, though?
No, it just made him try to run away, and then he ran into
so
the imaginary
wall. I can't do anything on my turn, because I'm knocked down.
Yeah. But he'll get up again. Just not now. Oh, goodness me, oh my.
Alright, so he's going to minus 1 toughness again. He's going to eradicate. It doesn't matter to me, because...
Irradiate.
So he's only got... I got to stand up now.
TP, stand him up, please. I can't reach over there.
Right there.
Just dash forward.
Dash him forward, please.
How far?
I don't think you need to dash.
6 spaces?
No, you just need to run.
Is that 6 spaces?
You moved equal to your movement.
5.
Okay. I wasn't sure. I know. So.
Prescription's as high.
My prescription.
What is your accuracy?
It's 5. 6 plus.
6 plus. You're gonna miss.
No, 5 plus.
You're gonna miss.
You want. Twitch, you want to have 3 people roll?
Sure.
Sorry.
What?
I've just been watching you guys roll horribly all night long.
We rolled 3 tens
really
in a
have
row
been rolling really
I
bad. You rolled 3 tens on stuff you couldn't even crit.
Yep.
And then Josh decided to give me the thing where I couldn't crit anymore, and I'm the guy with the
oh,
crit
died
weapons.
Died anyway, it didn't matter.
Thing?
The crit weapons.
3 dead so far. 3 out of 4.
And Zena's not here to watch this.
Nicholas rolled a 10.
That's a hit.
We're waiting for Gorgon Loves You and Mr. Frightful.
Gorgon Loves You.
And Gorgon Loves You has left us.
Left the building.
So I'm going to pull the next person to roll as well. Mr. Frightful rolled a 2.
Not a hit.
And Loyal Sim, if you could roll one more for us, please.
I rolled a 1.
Loyal Sim rolled an 8.
No, that's 2 hits.
Two hits.
So what are you attacking? You're attacking the...
Yeah. His big toe.
Serpent winged talon. So yes, the big toe. And then the serpent wings. So attack
kind of moving up his wing?
Pretty much. So right. Go for the first one.
Roll a d10, Twitch.
What's his toughness? He has minus two. So 11. You have what?
8.
So 3 plus. You're okay.
Cage, I'm placing my faith in you. Cage rolled a 4.
That's a wound.
That's a wound.
Ooh, okay. And then do we have another one?
Yes, you do.
Okay. Duxon, if you could roll for us.
A
also,
crit
please.
Would be really nice here.
Let's
crit would be
10.
Lovely. And I have deadly, so even a 9 would be fine. Did they actually, did they get a 10 in one of the hits?
Yes, they did.
I get plus 4 strength on that.
Ooh.
So, yeah, as long as you roll a 1. No, all my attacks.
Well, the only thing is this has a reflex.
I know. I'm just saying, but like, as long as they don't roll a 1, I
use Duxon for the 4.
That is a wound. Now turn to face the attacker.
There he is.
All survivors directly in front of the Dragon King suffer knockback 5. Without turning, move the Dragon King 2 spaces backwards. Place 2 lava pool tiles directly in front. That was there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, yeah. Now, the funny thing is, you're still in range of him.
But the lava pools make that a little bit difficult.
You're just gonna stand in lava. That's fine. It's good for you. Builds character.
Please tell me to stand in lava.
Suffer 1 damage and return all flammable gear to settlement storage. That's not that bad. It's 1 damage.
Tiny T-Rex arms.
You've got like 9 armor at every hit location. Being a pansy. Hey.
It's alright. He's gonna come towards me anyway.
It's like standing in a hot tub.
Alright. Much turn.
Yep.
Furthest threat in range. Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Furthest threat in range. That's you. Move and attack. 4 speed, 3 damage. 2 plus accuracy.
I have 4 evasion, so 6 plus.
6 plus. Oh, wow. You rolled great there.
Okay.
What's the damage?
3 damage each. But the funny thing is that you suffer knockback 20. I mean, you're on the board edge, so 6 it doesn't matter.
Damage to my waist. 3 damage to my body.
You could dodge one.
I only have 2 survival left.
Oh.
I'm not worried about it. He's going to get another minus toughness token.
Okay. It's going to irradiate. That's his irradiate.
Does it say irradiate?
No, I'm just saying that's him irradiating. Right. So you're going to take...
I don't get knocked down because I can bash with my leather armor.
Right.
So I stay where I am. I'm going to take 3 damage to a hit location.
Roll a dice.
Roll a dice. Let's speed this up. The body.
Yay. So it's your turn.
Right. TB, roll 2 dice.
1, 2,
3. 2 dice.
You can't get to the blind spot, unfortunately. Why 2? I thought it was 3 last time.
It was 3 last time.
Oops, it should have been 2. Sorry.
You cheater.
Cheater, pumpkin eater.
He still didn't beat it. Yeah. He's still gonna die.
The RX rolled a 9.
That's a hit. You got a fun one coming up next.
That's all.
It's not a tarp card.
No, it wasn't a tarp card. It was another card.
Kate's just marking out a queue. You can roll the physical dice right there. and we're just waiting for Nicholas Patton to roll another die.
Nicholas.
Sadly, I can't trip him by myself.
I think Nicholas has left the building, so I'm going to pull the next person.
How do you know he wasn't outside to begin with?
Mr. Frightful.
It's Mr. Frightful.
No, I'm going to do what everybody else does when they like disappear from the roll. It's like you're going to say, wow, genius can roll.
He's gonna put your headphones in.
Cat video.
You just gotta wait and be like, lag.
You're not on the internet unless you're looking at cat videos.
I have internet in the palm of my hand.
Welcome to the 21st century. No rolls?
Waiting for Mr. Frightful. Mm. Mr. Frightful rolled a 2.
That is not a hit. So, go ahead and roll a wound.
Do we need one more d10?
It's going to be like a 2 plus now.
1, 2, 3, 10, yeah, 2 plus.
Loyal Sim, if you could roll that for us.
Crit would be very nice here. He's got a lot of crit locations.
It's like most monsters.
Cage says the internet is for cats and porn.
The internet is really, really neat for porn!
Matt's never seen that. That's Avenue Q.
I know.
It is freaking awesome. One of the best Broadway shows ever.
Today's actually National Coming Out Day. Or was that yesterday?
That's today.
Today?
Yeah. It's okay, Matt. You come out now.
Thank you.
If you are gay, that'd be okay.
What was the roll?
3.
That's a wound. So the Dragon King leaps into the air with a blast of steam, place 2 lava pool tiles in the spaces the Dragon King occupies, then full move the Dragon King away from the attacker.
I'm okay with that.
They give you a lot of lava pool tiles here?
No. There's at least 2 more in here.
Okay, just giving you shit for not seeing Avenue Q, and I said that his daddy's gonna disown him.
Why don't you put it like 2 spaces down?
Why?
It's where he was, so I don't...
There. You happy? He occupies 4 spaces.
I know, I'm just saying, like, you could put it like here and here.
So he occupies 16 spaces then?
Yes.
All the spaces.
I was gonna say, that's not 4.
4 of those spaces.
Yeah, 4 of those tiles.
Alright, monster's turn?
Yeah, no, yeah, no, yeah.
Oh, sweet.
No, that was actually Crisis Crater. Dragon King grabs its massive foot, blah, 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 smash zone, perform basic action.
Shit.
Oh, man, I was about to be bad on your behavior.
No, yeah, you can dash. And you'll get far away, because his movement's only 10.
I meant for not watching.
That's not the issue.
Watching the show, not for being gay.
No, my comment.
Oh, okay.
That I'm typing right now.
Ah,
saying anyway.
Yeah, I see it.
Basic action.
Oh,
that's
so it's
turn. He's going to do it twice. He's going to melt down.
No, that's fine then. No. What you do is you Yeah, because it doesn't affect the side of him. Let him run up to you and attack him, and then dash and run up to
the
side.
That's why I wanted to see if I should run away. That's fine. All right, so he's going to run up and attack me. Speed of 3.
Accuracy of 6 plus.
6 plus.
2 hits.
2 hits.
Ooh, the head.
Damage. What the hell was that?
I only think the waste damage.
Surrogate?
I know, right?
Yeah, no, you just suck at spelling.
Oh, yeah, that's... I'm a product of the Broward County school system. Of course
I
do.
So it's Joshua.
So now you're gonna... dash to his side.
How far can I go with 6 spaces?
7.
I guess that's only an extra movement at the end of my act, not at the, using a dash.
You want to go to his side.
I do. I want to know if I could get out of the first...
No.
Yeah, just move me to side.
Move you right there.
Okay. There.
And now he's gonna
get the token. I get 4 damage to a hit location to the hand. That's actually perfect.
Any chance you'll actually win this?
Possibly.
He's got 3 health left.
Actually, yes, there's a good chance.
That's good.
No,
you know, that's such a disappointing, and you're a bunch of liars if you lose.
no, performs
right,
meltdown.
Yeah, so you're not in the view. Archives all destructible. Flip all lava pool terrain tiles to obsidian tower tiles.
Who suggested Dragon King?
You guys voted for
you guys. Chat did.
It Wait. Was Dragon King had 8 votes, and Gorm, Dung Beetle, and Lion God were tied at 6. So.
Right. So that's gonna get shuffled up.
Ooh, it's an intense fight. We all died so far, except for Josh.
Roll 2d10s.
You're gonna go to his butt?
No.
Why not? Why wouldn't you go to his butt? Go to his butt,
I
Joshua.
Go to his butt.
Cage and Dex, if you can roll for us, please. Cage rolled a 6.
That's a hit.
Yay, engulf in light.
Ooh,
it's an impervious, Josh.
Yeah, can't do anything. Yay.
He's gonna
just curse. You guys still need a swear jar.
Curse
under your breath just now.
You said I can't do anything. Yay! That's
before
all
that,
I said
before that.
Oh,
I'm playing back the stream.
Another 6.
Okay.
So first he's gonna irradiate.
Josh,
so you take 1 damage to your body, your chest, body,
my
whatever.
Armor, my chest. Okay.
And now we need a D10 to be rolled for the heart face.
1d10.
Yep.
Oh, damn it.
10. Oh, it's me?
Yeah. You want to roll out?
I mean, I'll skip you.
It's fine.
Oh,
you got a
crit. 9.
That's a crit.
Thank you.
Who's the rolling king now?
Mark's good for
gain
some.
1 survival and remove all minus 1 toughness tokens.
Alright. So that's a 3.
Okay, so Josh, move your clipboard, because every time you lean forward, you bump it with your tummy, and it moves the board forward.
Bump it with your tummy.
Do what I want.
I do what I want. I'm Rick James.
I'm assuming you want to attack again. You know you want to.
I wasn't watching Twitch that time. I was actually on Facebook.
I was
looking cat videos.
Let me see what actually what.
No.
Are you sure?
Don't you wanna, Fanta?
I'm coming up with a new game.
Oh, yeah?
Sure. I won't say it on the stream.
Maybe. I don't know what happened. I have a feeling his mood will come into play, which will minus 1 health to him.
Ah.
And he won't... I don't really care about it.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm hoping for.
There you go.
Ooh.
So now he's going to do what?
He's going to get minus 1 toughness token.
You take 1 damage to your head.
Which is fine.
And now it is your turn.
Yes. 2d10s, please.
2d10s.
If I win this by myself.
You're about to.
Pancakes will be...
A legend?
A legend.
The RX and Mr. Frightful. So, Josh, is that the last savior? Is that savior?
No, there's one more chilling at the
there's 2
settlement.
More.
No, but the savior is still alive. The,
yes.
The second savior.
The green savior is still alive, which is the best savior.
So, the RX rolled a 4, and
that's
Mr.
A hit.
Frightful rolled 6.
That's 2 hits. I forgot about the plus 1 accuracy, so it's a... Purpose.
Trap card. No, I'm kidding. You're attacking the bony chest sphincter.
Sphincter.
And the serpent chest. They both have the same exact reaction. I'm gonna do this one first.
Okay. So next up to roll. Please crit.
Twitch proxy, I need another d10 to be rolled.
One?
Yeah, for now. Two, really. Just do two. No.
Just one.
No, just one, because yeah, this could be bad. Oh, yeah, this could be really bad.
I get thrown in that corner?
Yeah.
I'm actually fine with that.
Oh, because you could go far away.
I go over here, and then he has to, like... He's only got one AA card left.
I would suggest moving him here. Moving you here because he can't reach you there? Technically can't reach you there.
Wilson rolled a 6.
That is a wound. But.
Actually, he only has basic action now.
So, Buster Kirby's Blaster KUB says, what reaction's up and why is it that ominous?
So, it's a wound, and because it's a wound, what the Dragon King doesn't like to be touched, full move towards the attacker. They're already adjacent. And they are snatched up and thrown. If the attacker is adjacent to the monster, which they are, place them in knockdown in an unoccupied corner of the showdown board. I suggest here.
I'm going to say over there.
He can't reach you here, and that
but
means...
But his eradicate will still hit me.
Irradiate. But it's only going to do two damage.
He does it twice.
Oh, okay. You're right.
And I can move or at least dash into to get
that's
into
true.
Him and hit
yeah,
him.
Yeah.
So if I'm knocked down over here, he
you
can't...
You beat it again.
Sorry.
You know, eventually that board's just going to fall right off the table.
All right. So...
Except the overload. There would be a weighted mini right there.
Yeah, right.
He's going to move... Ah!
10 spaces.
10 spaces.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And that's archived. Archive that.
Did he run over the other thing too?
Yeah.
Alright. Eradicate.
Irradiate.
Irradiate. Get the normal minus toughness token.
He irradiates again.
Irradiates again. Get the normal minus toughness token.
That actually made it easier for you to hurt him now.
Yes.
So now
I get
it's...
up.
Do you get up? Yeah, you get up. You dodged his blind spot.
What?
Dodge to his blind spot. You might as well.
Or use just a survival and try to hit again.
Whatever.
Sure, I'll dodge, whatever.
Dodge.
I'm doing. Move me.
Dash.
Dash, or whatever.
Dodge, duck, dip, dive, dodge, and dash. Get in his butt, Josh.
And okay, dodge.
So Josh's belly needs to have its own label on the
other. Okay.
That's mean.
I know.
We need 2d10s to be rolled, please. And what's the accuracy, Josh? 4 plus, 3 plus, 3 plus.
2d10s, you say?
Yeah, 2d10s. I kind of want to really hit my shield, get my shield proficiency, but I'm not.
Why don't you?
Cage and ducks, we can roll for
6 plus,
please?
And only has 1 strength.
Oh, yeah, you're not going to hit him.
But I just need to kill him.
He's just mad because he's got really long fingernails, and he can't do anything with them.
It's really great for scratching, though. Imagine if he's got an itchy back. It's going to be great.
Cage rolled a 7.
That's a hit.
Mr. Frightful linked to Mark's Kickstarter. Thanks, Mr. Frightful.
Oh, that's dead.
Get over.
Oh, I got 2 hours left. And
if anyone wants back for like $2,500, we
can trade. Oh, wait, back and actually have $2,500 to spend? That'll be awesome.
So what happens if someone did back that, but like their credit card declined? Is it still considered?
No idea.
Is it still considered funded?
It would still be considered funded, but if it didn't go through, it would be a bad scene.
What happened?
We were talking about like what if someone backed for $2,500, but with a non-working credit card, and the Kickstarter technically funded, but the payment couldn't go through. Would still be considered funded.
It's got a week to go through, and then I would probably be hitting up Indiegogo like a mofo. As it stands, we're looking at seeing if the backers want us to restart the campaign with a $7,000 pledge goal, because I was able to get it down after talking to a few people. And
don't throw your phone.
You can't call me.
Don't be that upset. It's preferable to 6.
That's another hit.
Oh, wait.
It's one hit to kill, so what's worse? Best.
You have to wound this one to get the reaction, so you should attack this one.
Okay.
So, D10, please.
Trying to be smart asses.
Huh?
Blaster says 1 week warning for people trying to be smart asses. D10 is going to be VRX. If you could roll that for us, please.
That's the prescription.
My sister thought this was 10, so I need 2 plus.
2 plus.
So basically, anything's going
to. Well, I think I was going to run it for the month of November.
Did RX roll an 8?
RX rolled an 8. How'd you know that?
Because I saw it in chat.
You little cheetah!
He's so,
dead.
Josh killed the
He's
serpent
dead.
King,
by
or
himself.
The dragon king,
literally
all by himself.
Literally by himself, because we died like in the beginning.
I get 400 XP. I age up.
So, go ahead and roll for the age.
Have Twitch roll 2d10s. 2d10s?
Is that your second one?
Yes, my second one. I get another vision.
Loyal Simming Cage, if you could roll for that, please.
You're just in Cage to roll?
This actually doesn't matter, and low numbers are not bad.
Yeah.
You rolled a 1.
That's fine.
It's actually not terrible.
Still funny.
50-50 shot of getting +1 permanent strength.
I'm not even in the queue, am I?
See, because he rolled a physical die.
It doesn't automatically re-add you to
it. Oh, that's kind of funny.
When you roll it, when you roll on the thing.
And Loyal Sim rolled a 1, so we got Snake Eyes.
Oh, +1 permanent movement.
I have 7 movement, 8 movement with my
boots.
My boots.
That's funny. It's much better if you roll Snake Eyes for the first age, because then you get +1 permanent evasion.
Ooh.
Okay, so.
And what else do we get?
The first time the Dragon King is defeated, add the Dragon Armory to the settlement location.
Okay, so we'll add that.
The group. It's just pancakes. Pancakes gain the following rewards: 4 basic resources and 4 Dragon King resources.
Does he get anything for us dying?
Like, a bunch of.
We get a bunch of endeavors.
I got more dung.
You got more poop.
Horn fragment, cabled vein, and king's claws.
Everyone's cheering for pancakes.
Pancakes, pancakes, pancakes.
Maybe I should have stopped at a different place.
IHOP for everyone.
Why IHOP?
Oh, it's International House of Pancakes.
I know.
You're so dumb.
What else do we have? 4 basic resources?
4 basic and 4 Dragon King.
Pray for no heart. Is pancake, in fact, the new hope?
Maybe.
Pancakes is just pancakes.
Bones.
You know they're going to vote for like a new survivor named Syrup and Butter or something like that.
Butter.
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 B-U-T-T-H.
If people want to do that, do Katie Pohl so they can go enter that in.
Oh, we got another love juice.
Yes.
Baby Megan. Baby Bacon.
Okay.
Okay. That's it. So, Josh, is there anything that happens now in the settlement events?
Nah, gotta get waffles.
Oh, God.
Yeah, pancakes and waffles.
Pancakes and waffles.
That's gonna be the new savior right there.
That better be the new savior.
Waffles.
Waffles.
So you could waffle stomp.
Oh, my God, Matt.
Huh? What?
You had to
that's
go.
The other, that's a shiny one.
Is it?
Yes, that's a shiny one.
I can't see that.
I guarantee you that's a shiny one.
Okay, just what would it have been out of curiosity?
There was a shiny one.
What was it? Is it
belted? The belt.
Oh, okay. Haunted! The survivor with the lowest hunt XP is...
Returning?
It just says the survivor with the lowest hunt XP.
Okay, so just...
Just period, the survivor with the lowest hunt XP.
Yeah. Choose in case of a tie. So you get to choose.
So we have sausage...
We also need a D10 to be rolled.
Who's sausage?
Sausage is the no.
Who was the savior?
I wrote it on the top. I wrote blue. It's over here. It's no. It was Spider Ham. Yeah, here it is. Spider Ham.
Spider Ham. Spider Ham.
2D10, you said?
Yes, 2D10.
Sausage or no? We'll do a. If I die, I'm not single forever. He's been haunted.
Forgot we had that one.
Yep.
We need a D10 to be rolled.
The RX rolled a 10. Mr. Piper rolled a 7.
I just won one
D10. You said 2 before.
You did say 2.
I did?
Yeah.
Oh, well, 10. Do we have Memento Mori?
No.
The survivor paints their blood in patterns all over the settlement. They permanently gain +2 strength, +1 accuracy, and the following ability. Possessed cannot use weapon specialization, weapon mastery, or fighting arts. Okay. So +2 strength, +1 accuracy. Why couldn't you have picked, like, Sausage or someone where they've got like good starting stats.
I thought it was gonna be bad stuff. I think if you roll low, it's bad.
Probably. Oh, Jesus.
Bad stuff?
You know, it's actually not bad for them, but if they roll a 1 through 3, you can't spend any endeavors this settlement phase. Yeah, that would have been terrible, considering we just got a buttload of them. Okay, so plus 2 strength, plus 1 accuracy. So he's like a newborn baby now.
Yeah.
That sucks.
Alright, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Endeavors. Always be innovating. So we're going to innovate, and Twitch Proxy, we're going to need a poll to be readied up.
Okay. Okay, what's the question?
What do you want to endeavor?
Okay. Question?
Storytelling. Arena.
Okay.
Heart flute. And sacrifice. Sacrifice.
The heck.
You start giving her pets, she won't
I
stop.
I spelled that wrong, but whatever.
Okay, so what do they do? Storytelling. Increases our survival limit by 1, which is always good. And on the roll of an 8+, we get to do white speaker. Do you want to do white speaker?
It's if you roll really well, something good happens. If you roll badly, something horrible happens.
Yeah.
You have enough population, you want to sacrifice people. That's just fun.
And I believe storytelling has some other benefits, too. Then there's arena, which you can spend an endeavor and spar. Spend an iron and an endeavor to spar. Gain a scar, plus 1 permanent strength, and skip the next hunt. If you already have a scar, the wound reopens, you bleed out and die. Plus one on accuracy, gain the Frozen Star Secret Fighting Art. That's interesting. So that looks like... Are you sure we're supposed to have this one in there? Because this is for the Dragon King expansion.
Yeah, it's still... I believe it's still okay. Allowed.
The Heart Flute. You play the Devil's Melody. Flat note, add a Nemesis encounter to the storyline next year. On roll 6+, select any Nemesis encounter, special encounter them, you may choose the level. So that's the one I was telling you about, where we can just do the hand every year and... kind of game that one. And then sacrifice allows us to possibly kill people and move the Nemesis encounter watcher back on the timeline by a year. I don't think that's particularly great. These are all kind of poopy.
Nothing.
What would you choose?
Storytelling adds a couple of cards to the thing, and the plus one survival element's nice.
Yeah.
And the arena... Arena's not bad.
Storytelling with 1 go.
Story arena's not bad. Heart flute is that for the white lion?
I think storytelling's the white lion, but it's the level 3 and yada yada.
That's true. I don't want to fight that.
I didn't pay attention to anything. I just picked one that. It won't let me vote.
Oh, I ended it.
Oh,
sorry.
Damn it.
So storytelling.
Storytelling.
Okay, that's one.
Sorry. Totally unrelated conversation.
Okay, so we have a buttload. We have 6 endeavors.
Lester says sacrifice is tempting but too risky, if you ask me. And Cage's heart food is Manhunter, if I recall correctly.
Huh.
If we had him in the Nemesis thing, we could do that. Yeah.
You know how bad you guys could be just thinking about it. You guys could be really screw people over and do like a Pandemic Legacy.
We're talking about doing a Pandemic Legacy, actually.
Nobody would watch it. I have it.
Charles, this is that mark right here. Yes, it is.
It is. So, Josh, what are we going to do with our endeavors?
What? Are we doing another year?
I don't think we have time for another year, but we can finish off the settlement phase this turn. Make a bunch of babies. What do you say?
We can make a bunch of babies. I don't think we have anything else to really do.
Okay, so once
see, people, I told you the gays can have babies.
Look over the different armor or gear we can make, and I'm going to start having them roll for babies. I'm going to have them do love juice first.
Yeah, that's fine.
So, Twitch Proxy, I need 2d10s to be rolled for the love juice.
Okay, it's
going to
be Cage and Loyal Sim.
And that is for our intimacy.
Okay, rolled an 8.
We need a 10 here. That's Cajun Loyal Sim, you said?
Cajun Loyal Sim.
It's not the bolt.
Duck says Matt is whispering to Josh, make a bunch of babies, wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Loyal rolled a 9.
Twins!
Twins! Waffle and Strong?
Waffle stomp.
You know what waffle stomping is, right, Mark?
Dumber.
There are some terms I know that this is a clean stream, so no, I'm not gonna. I'll say yes, I do.
Okay. So we need. If you want to, are we gonna name them now, Josh, or are we gonna wait for the next?
No.
We need the next two names from the poll.
Next two names are going to be. We got a lot of votes. We already used sausage. We already used spider ham.
Spider ham.
Okay. So now it's tied between Ditto, Ivysaur. Matt's an illegitimate bastard.
What's the freaking poll?
Roll and Jesse.
What's he most thinking poll? What jet lag?
So feel free to choose that for us there, TP. You got the deciding factor.
I haven't voted yet.
Not allowed.
What? I'm taking my shit and going home.
That's kind of cool. I want it. And it's devastating one also. Mm-hmm. That's solid. Give me. Make it for me.
I can make that. That's like the only thing I make.
I want it.
The quiver's kind of cool too.
It's the quiver.
But I don't have the...
You may activate and gain the benefits of each arrow in your gear grid one additional time. Aw, I'll make it.
Yeah.
Make it.
Yeah.
Make it.
Who the hell spelled Phoenix that way?
Probably me.
Definitely you, Josh.
100% you.
Yeah.
Pahonix?
Pahonix, yeah.
I copy it every time. I never fixed it because I forget that it's wrong, so... I need another wing. I only have one.
Can't Panda Panda Guide.
Panda.
Mushroom. No. Okay, do you have enough points to gamble 100? I am disappointed in you.
So, Twitch Proxy, I'm waiting on you to tell me the names.
I'm trying to get to the names. Oh, there's the names.
I'm waiting for Mark. Apparently Mark wants to vote.
Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch?
Yes, Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch.
I will throw a taco at you, sir.
Don't throw the Dilla.
Someone broke the tie.
I wonder who that could be.
The next name is going to be Jesse.
Is that a male or a female Jesse?
Actually, it was not me. Somebody else did, because I voted for Dr. Pepper.
Female.
Okay.
And Mark's vote for Dr. Pepper.
Well, Sergeant Pepper, but...
Sergeant Pepper.
Is Sergeant Pepper a doctor?
No,
a field doctor.
Dr. Pepper now.
Does not break the tie, so the next one is going to be Ditto.
Okay, Ditto. And that's a male. Sure, why not? Jesse and Ditto. Okay, so we still have 6 endeavors left. Let's have an augury roll.
Okay, so
1d10.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
Language. The prescription. D10, please. Rolled a 5.
5, yes.
That is not an augury, a baby. So, another D10. So we had 7 total. We used 2.
Am I in the queue still?
You should be.
I don't know.
Well, that sucks for the Christians.
What?
Kedrith?
Mr. Frightful rolled a 9.
It's babies. We need 2d10s to be rolled.
2d10s.
And that is for our intimacy check.
Kadrit said that this is a Christian stream, Mark.
Cage rolled an 8. Mark, are you going to roll?
Oh, well, wait, no, wait, hold on. I'll see which roll's better.
You don't get to choose.
Cheater, pumpkin eater.
pumpkin spice cheater.
Oh my god, I want a pumpkin spice latte.
Oh, jeez, you're so white. I rolled a 9.
Oh, twins! Thank you, Mark.
Mark made twins.
Are you that surprised?
Mark is very fertile.
Mark has killed
so,
a baby.
Four babies from three baby mamas.
So we need...
Three babies from four baby mamas.
Twitch proxy.
Yes.
We need more character sheets, Josh.
More names?
Yeah, we're out.
More names?
Yeah, I need two more names.
Matt, illegitimate bastard.
It'd be Mark's illegitimate bastard.
That's Matt.
Oh, God.
Just write them on here, and then I'll make sheets for them.
And it's going to be a tie between Ivysaur and...
Oh, you got
to
vote
again,
don't I?
Ivysaur it is.
Okay.
Okay, so we use 3 of our 7 endeavors, so let's get another augury roll. Time to get that population
Royal
up.
Royal Sim. If you can roll for that, please.
If only we had bed.
If only you have beds? What?
Yeah, we don't have beds. We're just doing it on the ground right now.
Wow.
If you have beds, your babies...
Strong knees.
Your babies are stronger if you have beds, though. Plus one strength babies.
Plus one strength babies.
That...
Royal Sim rolled an 8.
That is Baby Megan. So we need 2 more D10s to be rolled for intimacy.
2 more D10s. The RX and Mr. Frightful.
Let's make some babies. I wonder if we're going to get another 9.
Mr.
Frightful
rolled a 6.
Okay. And who else is supposed to be rolling? The RX. The prescription. Do it. Do it. Do it.
Do it now.
Get to the chopper.
So I have 80 minutes to raise $2,600. I don't think it's happening.
You never know.
Yeah, you never know.
Derek says, y'all been around in that settlement for how long without laying on a random pelt? So not the smartest people. Derek rolled a 1, so does a 6 create a baby?
Yes, a 6 makes a baby.
Okay, so 1 more.
Hey, what's the other name that we had? That was tied with Ivysaur?
Roll.
Roll, yes.
I need another D10 to be rolled for the augury.
D10.
We use this, by the way.
Yeah.
Kate rolled a 10.
The baby making.
That's baby making.
So 2 more.
Too bad that that wasn't on the actual intimacy table, because that would have been another savior.
Vile Genius and Loyal Sim, if you could each roll 1 D10.
Because then we could have made Panda.
Oh, Panda, Mushroom.
That's not how that song goes.
That's totally how that song goes.
Better, Mushroom.
Honey
mushroom.
Badger, don't give up.
Wait, what am I supposed
a
to
do? A darn. D10.
What are you rolling over there?
Okay. I was going to gamble.
Oh,
right, that's my lowest. That's my lowest.
3,
roll.
2, 3. So there's no babies.
Oh, that's not good.
So next.
No. Hold on.
No more.
Who was the female survivor that was having the babies, Josh?
No.
Did we just have a miscarriage?
The female survivor perishes with her child during childbirth. The settlement is cast in gloom. The male survivor mourns, gaining a random disorder and 3 insanity.
I said it was the deep fried Oreo.
Deep fried Oreo's dead. No.
And Sausage was given deep fried Oreo his sausage.
So that? Please give Sausage a disorder.
Well, Sausage should be giving Roll. No, Sausage.
Roll was just born.
Roll can't make a baby.
Technically, they could, but that's weird.
It's only weird if Sausage was his father and also given him the sausage. Then
so who killed him? Did I kill him or somebody else?
You both killed him
together.
I grabbed one. I grabbed unlucky again, so I'm cursed.
Stark Raving, you are always insane.
That's not bad.
So Sausage is always insane.
Because he killed
Sausage. Because he killed Sausage Party, now you know why.
Okay, so we need another D10 to be rolled for the augury. And this is going to be our 6th endeavor.
Mr. Frightful.
Yes, puppy?
Do we have anything else we want to use the last endeavor for, Josh?
Nothing.
Shrine, maybe? Plus 1 armor?
Do we have Shrine?
Yes. Oreo's dead. Mr. Frightful rolled a 5.
Okay, and does that make a baby?
No, it doesn't.
Okay. Okay, so we have one more.
No, hold on. We're going to see if we want to do one more thing, maybe.
I don't know what
rank. But we... But
raise
we,
the ranking of it. It's a 1 right now, so we can make it a 2. And I think that makes it better for when it does come around.
I don't know. You tell me, boss man. I don't know.
Decide now.
Get on my face.
She's not pep talk. She doesn't care about the face blowing. She don't care.
Who does?
It's like basically petting me with air.
We could do a shrine too.
Do the shrine. Roll a d10, Twitch proxy.
How many endeavors do we have left?
1.
You want to do that or do you want to raise that?
Sure, we'll do this. I don't care. You tell me.
I think that we spent all those that time and endeavors to do
that. The arts rolled a 7.
I don't know what that does. We'll find out. Tune in now time.
It just says to raise it. It doesn't.
Does that? Oh. You may spend 1 preserved caustic dung.
Oh, I can't. So, yeah.
You don't read.
Whatever.
A 7, so all departing survivors on the next hunt get +1 armor to each hit location.
Okay.
That's handy. Handy dandy. And I believe that's everything, right, Josh?
Yeah, we're not doing another hunt.
We are not doing another hunt right now. Okay, so this concludes our broadcast of Twitch Plays Kingdom Death. We almost all died. Almost a TPK.
So our next stream is on Thursday, which is...
How to play session.
How to play of Tokeyono?
Yes.
I said it right.
You tell me.
Saturday is our... that's at 8 p.m. Saturday is our Pathfinder stream at 5.
Eastern Standard Time.
Eastern Standard Time. Monday is a spotlight stream of... we're not sure yet. We have a lot backed up, but we just need to make sure...
We need a big one.
And then next week, same bat time, same bat channel, we're going to be doing our next Lantern Year for Twitch Plays Kingdom Death, going into Lantern Year 16. Is that a Nemesis encounter?
No, just a normal year.
Just a normal one. So if you guys go, vote in the KD polls.
It is a Nemesis encounter. I'm sorry.
You say things, and you don't look. It's like.
So you guys still get the vote on what Nemesis we fight.
It's like for the generator. Oh, we should be good on gas. We'll check that. Oh, we don't have any gas.
Really?
I got gas. It wasn't like...
Because I questioned him.
I was going to go check the generator end of it and make sure it was working still. And I would have checked the gas then, but...
So, Mark's in the last, like, hour of his Tales from the Tavern.
So anyone wants to give him, like, $2,000?
$2,600, yeah. There's actually... I did actually put up a 20... Oh, I should probably lower that. I put up a $2,900 pledge level and giving people for the next 5 campaigns... they get to be, it's the ego tiers, where you become a...
Ah, gotcha.
For the ones they want, plus all deluxe versions of those games as well. So I probably should change that down to 2,600.
See, just like that, you're getting a better deal now. But yeah, so thank you all for joining us, and tune in next time. This has been another TGN broadcast. I'm Matt.
I'm Josh.
I'm Twitch Proxy, and have a good night.
Good night, everyone.